And welcome, everybody, to Nat 1 Fun. Welcome back to Running Feywild. I know we've been gone for a few weeks, but I hope you had a great few weeks, and I know I did. So, yeah, we're back, everybody. We're back. It's been a little bit of a hiatus. We've had a lot of things happen in the last few weeks. Yeah, it's just been, it's been a really shitty time for some, and it's been a really great time for others. So, it's been a bunch of bullcrap. But before we get started, let's all give a nice, warm shout-out to our very own Brandon, Burnout Paladin Nate, who is a new father. I guess a second-time new father.
It's tired. It's called being tired. That's
yeah.
The title.
Yeah, is that it? I mean, honestly, you've had 2 hours of sleep. Get over it, you know what I'm saying?
So like, Brandon's... Son? Daughter?
Daughter.
Sorry. Daughter. Our newest player.
She's a whole week old, so she can...
Yay!
She can definitely come on the stream.
There you go.
Listen, level one, baby!
She's already older than Jimmy.
I like how well that came out. I was like, wow, that was better than it should have been. That was good.
Put a barbarian in front of her and just let her go and just let her throw some d12s. We'll be good to go.
I don't know if I trust grandma with her though.
Well, grandma raised you, Nate.
Yeah, I know. That's the problem.
Exactly. I believe
what's
that's the problem.
About Nate? Okay. All right. So let's go ahead and run through our lovely affiliations today. We have, of course, our lovely Diehard Dice affiliation, who are just incredible. And are just a continuing source of amazing and incredible dice, especially metal and dire D20s and stuff like that. They have some amazing dice sets. So if you want to save some money, go to dieharddice.com and type in the code NAT1FUN, and you'll save yourself 10% off any purchase that you make while you're there. And that can save you some big money if you end up making like a larger dice purchase, which I say you probably should because honestly, they're great. And I believe they got some new dice coming down the line as well. So, let's see. Second off, we have ExpressVPN. If you are not privy to what ExpressVPN is, it is a VPN, which allows you to basically browse the internet without having, you know, the internet police down your back. So basically you can browse securely without having any kind of worries that your computer might get hacked into or whatever you're using might get hacked into, as well as being able to kind of virtually locate yourself around the world. So if you see that there is a Netflix show, but it's only available in the EU and you're in the US, you can just switch your location and the website believes that you are in the other location. And all of a sudden you have access to whatever you need.
I wonder what kind of people do that.
I don't know what that's supposed to be. Really smart people who use VPNs.
Yeah, clearly. Not me every day.
Yeah, I was about to say, I think that's what you're implying.
Yeah. No, I mean, I'm with you.
Yeah. So anyways, if you can or if you'd like to, you can go to expressvpn.com/nat1fun, and that'll allow you to kind of basically buy different packages from them. You can buy like 1 month, 3 months. But if you buy their 12-month package, it'll allow you to get 3 months additionally for free. So, yeah, head on over there and get yourself a VPN because they're very useful and safe.
Get it.
Last but not least is the incredible 1985 Games. 1985 Games is an amazing website that you can use if you are a DM on the go or if you are a DM looking for inspiration. Or anything else. They have like a plethora of GM tools that you can use in your everyday games. Our Monday night show here on Nat 1 Fun is even dedicated to one of the items they have there, which is called the Deck of Stories. The Deck of Stories is an awesome card set, as you can see
right
here. Like playing cards.
I got a set right here too, man.
I got
the Gothic one. I feel you.
There you go. So they also have expansions for it. But what this is basically a big deck full of story prompts that allow you to build a story or build a scenario in your game, be it D&D, be it Cthulhu, be it like whatever game you're playing. You can make these cards fit to whatever your story is, and it immediately gives you an idea for whatever you want to play. It's really good, really easy to kind of lean into as a GM and build a story from. So You can check out those cards and many more things at 1985games.com. But if you use our affiliate link in chat, 1985, the affiliate link is 1985games.com/p/not1fun, and that'll lead you to their website. And if you want to save 10% off as well, use not1fun during checkout, and you can save yourself some money. And that is about it. Now, I will say the little meter down here is broken. That's not at 75% or $75. That should be $25. That is where we were at the last time our Wild Magic gauge was up. So if $25 is donated today at some point during the stream, a Wild Magic surge will happen in the world somewhere, well, probably close to our players. So if you're feeling generous, or if you're feeling a little mischievous, you can always donate up to that $50 mark. Now every $50 will do that. So if you want to just be just super generous today, you can do $75 and all of a sudden two will go off the same. So anyways, that is pretty much all I have for today. Also down there, as you can see, it says Electrum chess code none this week. That was me forgetting to get a code for this week. Sorry. they don't automatically generate, so I have to go and ask for a code every time we play. And I totally spaced on this week, so my apologies.
But a lot of things happen in the world.
Yeah, we had a lot of stuff go down, so I totally forgot. But before we get started too, I do want to say that...
Stash Mandio.
Hey, thank you very much for the sub, Stash. Welcome back in for
the glorious second mustache. Glorious mustache is here.
Yes. You can enjoy your little dragon there that you have next to your name now.
Little dragon.
So what I was going to say was, announcement-wise, I had an announcement. Oh, I did have an announcement. Running Feywild will officially be swapping over from a weekly campaign to a bi-weekly campaign. So from now on, every time you view us here live on Twitch, 2 weeks from then will be the next live show. But that doesn't mean that we're not going to be putting out content every week. So whatever you missed that previous week will be uploaded to YouTube. And hopefully here soon, I will start being able to put out the podcast.
I'm waiting for.
Really, really started to overload myself with things because we were on a weekly basis, and I was literally running like a train while it was, you know, basically putting the tracks down while the train was moving, and I ran out of tracks. So the train stopped. You know, I had the idea of having a podcast along with it, but the weekly campaign was a little much. So, bi-weekly campaign, and expect that you can check out our podcast coming up soon. Now, with that, if you want early access to the podcast, you can always check out our Patreon. These lovely individuals around me here are being supported by you guys. You as individuals can go over to our Patreon, which is just patreon.com/runningfeywild, and you can help support these individuals and help me pay for them to be here. They are giving me their lovely time and talent, and I think that just by showing your appreciation through that is just a wonderful way of doing things. So, on top of the fact that you are supporting them, you get access to behind-the-scenes stuff, such as post-game interviews or post-game, you know, talks. You also get access to any excess material that we are going to be putting forth here in the future. Maybe early access to merchandise, which I have on my board as well, of things that I want to start putting out there. And early access to the podcast. So it's really beneficial. And again, like I said, it benefits these lovely individuals here. So thank you all for listening to my spiel. I apologize. It was kind of corporate, if you will. I know it was a talk about a lot of money, but... kind of switching gears now, we are going to jump into kind of a little bonus section that I like to that I'm trying to implement at the beginning of all our episodes now, and it's a little section that I don't have a name for just yet, but we will come up with a name. But we're going to tell a little bit about our characters' backstory slash maybe a little fact about them, a factoid of them. That maybe you wouldn't be able to get in this game particularly. So let's kind of start it off with, we're going to go around the border. Let's go with Pooja. Pooja, tell me something about Svara that is interesting.
An interesting thing about Svara is that she is currently in the middle of a professional crisis. Yep, no one knows about it. I don't think Angie knows about it even. It's just, yeah, she's having that mid-20s professional crisis.
Oh, no.
Would Santosh know about it? Would she have divulged it? Not even to Santosh.
Oh, damn.
No.
So it's just like a total inner monologue style thing.
Yeah, this is an inner monologue thing because, as a recap, Svara is very successful in the financial industry, has an incredibly lucrative job and a very respectable career, and is kind of not willing to admit yet to herself that she has a professional crisis.
All right, this is well, this is some behind the scenes there. Thank you very much, Santosh. Excuse me.
Actually, if I could go next, because yes. I need to help put the baby to bed real quick.
Go for it, bro.
So, the thing about Nate, and it's kind of a Nate and Grandma thing, is that they have been keeping something from Dan Danielson himself.
Okay.
Man, we're going deep today.
Oh, damn.
That one's good.
I want everybody to text me these secrets because I can't live knowing that there's these things now. I'm like, what is just tell me, just tell okay, me what it is.
Dan, like, you told us to collude behind your back, and we did. Like,
I did. I wanted you to collude. I wanted you to come up with a story, so I'm glad you did. I'm happy.
I'll be back in 2 minutes.
I'm also interested to know why Dan wouldn't know about it, kind of thing, you know what I'm saying?
We were afraid to tell you because we weren't sure if you were Dan.
Oh.
Well, that's a kind of a convoluted question, I guess. It's, I don't know.
Think about that one. Think all right. About that.
Well, since we're on the topic, Grandma, what do you got?
All right. Well, Grandma has a old, dusty Tums bottle in her dresser full of Dan and Nate's teeth.
I'm sorry, what?
The baby ones. And there was, you know, a couple wisdom teeth in there that she specially asked to keep. Because if you ask, they'll give them to you.
Yeah, sure.
And like those are wrapped in like a little square of Kleenex and just shoved down in there. But they're all in there, all of them. Even the one that Nate like cracked on the way out and ate part of it, but like the rest she got.
Okay. I'll just say that I'm very glad this is not in character knowledge because it really might change
Siddharth's
feelings on.
It might.
Sir Ma.
Right. You have to keep those things, you know? Like, that's a grandma.
You don't
job.
Have to. That's, I don't know where you're getting the have to part. Okay.
Dan,
My grandma kind of saved a bunch. So I'm like,
Judy, you know what it.
I feel like, I was like, not everyone, but when you said Kleenex, I was like, she did put, like, there was, like, some tissues with some
everybody
teeth in it one
out
time
there
I found.
With
this is a thing.
With a guardian that has done this. You all know. Everybody across
the
globe
I've experienced.
Like, ooh. And sometimes you find that thing and you're like, whoa.
Y'all are not worried enough about being cloned. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, well, I was a kid, but now 23andMe, they ain't getting me. I'm not. Oh, I don't give God. My DNA. They already got all my other information. They don't need my
okay,
DNA.
But
all
right. Should I be worried about it or should the world be worried about it?
Mm-hmm. Noah, what about you? You got something?
I guess this is I was going to come up with a cool secret, but I'm going to go with the dumb thing I thought of originally.
Mm-hmm.
Noah went through a period in his life where he thought he was supposed to be left-handed because his mom's left-handed. But he, you know, so he didn't really think about it. But then he has younger siblings, and there's a gap, but then they're also left-handed. Like, there was one, and then the next one was born after that, and mm-hmm. that one was left-handed. So he was not a little kid. He was already, like, established, like, in school. I don't know if it was, like, five or seven, so he could already write, but because his mother and then his younger siblings mm-hmm. were left-handed, around the age of seven, where it's clearly like, you know, he's figured it out, he tried to start trying to go left-handed because he thought he was wrong.
Okay.
So it's something where he, I think, tried to convince his immediate family that he's left-handed. So if he is around his immediate family and ever needs to write something, he tries to write left-handed.
So
and he's gotten decent. He's gotten decent after years of it, because it is the dumbest thing. He doesn't need to. He could just be right-handed. But growing up, he thought he was the outlier, so he wanted to not be weird.
Got it.
So he tries to be left-handed when he's around his family. He's right-handed everywhere else.
That's a deep cut. All right.
Amazing.
Pulling back over to Santosh.
I was going to say, my dad is kind of like that, where almost everything he does, he's right-handed, except when he plays cricket.
Oh, okay.
He plays cricket left-handed. Because actually, originally, he was left-handed, and then he learned right-hand because in India, left-handedness is kind of considered inauspicious, because using the left hand is considered inauspicious for things. So he had to learn right-handedness. So he does, like, he eats food and everything else left-handed. But then when he plays cricket, that's mm-hmm. his hand. So that's, there you go.
That's some real life lore for you there, ladies and gents.
It happens.
I have things like that too, don't worry.
Yeah.
Random left-handedness is
guys,
awesome.
We can become famous and buy followers, primes, and viewers if we click this link.
Legas!
I've been waiting for this message.
Bot!
Jesus Christ.
Oh, man.
You should have deleted it faster because I already clicked it and phone is
no,
my phone is smoking.
It shouldn't be smoking,
but it's already smoking.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, we're going to lose Noah for a bit. That's fine.
I feel like now that we know that fact about KP's dad, they have to come play now.
That would be interesting.
It's like you gave enough information that it's too late. Like, that was...
Yeah. The one of us. Okay.
So I'm gonna text him. And...
the fact that you may have his number is more concerning.
Well, I clicked that link, so I've got a lot of things.
So. As far as Santosh's little secret, oh boy.
Oh my god. Okay.
He's always been the type that just lives with everything out in the open, right? He doesn't really hide much, or at least tries not to hide much. And I think last time I've been talking about how he's kind of had slight insecurities, though, about his life. He never thought he would regret it. Like, he always thought he loved being carefree. But there are moments where he sees Swara succeeding and getting the accolades and getting the praises. Mm-hmm. And even just like anybody else, he always wanted that. So he actually has been considering going back to school to get an education on something. He doesn't know what. Doesn't know where, how, and maybe a conversation was in the works to be had with his sister about where his direction should be.
Is Santosh's like consideration? Is his consideration just like thinking about it and saying like, yeah, yeah, and then that's it, and then he keeps
going
back.
No, that's literally how it is. He's not gone. Looked into any pamphlets or looked at what schools he wanted to do or what programs okay. they had. It was more of a, yo, I should get an education, bro. It's like one day he was so high and he was with his Hell friends. Yeah. And he goes, dude, I should probably finish my degree, man. You know?
Like, one guy's like, finish, you started one?
Oh, you're right. Oh, shit. I should probably start one.
Bro.
There's a very bro moment between the two. I love it.
Suddenly just dropped into dude, where's my car?
It's bro,
dude,
where's my degree?
It is bro, where's my degree?
Yeah.
So, fun fact about Dan. I know we didn't do one last time, but fun fact about Dan Danielson is that he used...
missing.
Right. Is that he used to actually work. For a living, he used to work. He worked at a tabletop board game store.
That's what he said when he'd go there every day. But
right, no, he was a volunteer worker. Right, no, He worked there, but he was fired. He was obviously fired. It was because someone came in there asking a simple question, and that led him on a tirade that eventually he found himself on top of the roof of the building, to which the cops and the firefighters all had to be called. He had to be calmed down, and essentially, he was fired. So, I mean, he was a worker.
Dude needs a chill.
I was really hoping it would have been like all that happened and he wasn't fired, but then he was fired for like giving somebody incorrect change.
Yeah. Oh my god.
I was hoping it'd be like
the place is just as bad as he is, and he was just fired for giving incorrect change, and he was only fired because it, you know, the law was being brought in and they had to be.
Boss, Mr. Krabs.
Yeah, sorry. All right. Well, on that note, let's go ahead and get started with today's session. So, as I have forgotten to do 100 times before, let's go ahead and roll our intro, and then we'll get into the game.
Oh, this intro.
Did we miss last time?
Yeah, sure did.
Oh.
It's such a, like, intro. You only toss this together in, like, 4 minutes. It's easy to forget.
I wasn't sure where that was going, and I got really nervous. Yeah,
I play too straight sometimes, and people... I have to... Oh, I'm talking. I always have to tell people, hey, look, I'm not kidding, or hey, this is a joke, because I sometimes play it too serious, and people are like, oh my god, where is he going with this? Where is he going?
Ooh. All the way to the Feywild.
So, we are, we're looking at the Feywild here. Let's go ahead, and we are going to do what I have created, I guess, as a, like, our... go-to thing when we talk about what happened last time.
You've set a precedent.
I feel like we did.
It.
You did this yourself.
If you missed, yeah, I really did. So if you missed last episode, enjoy our little, what is it called? Like a romance novel? What are they called?
A light novel?
It's a dating sim.
A dating sim?
Like a dating sim.
Dan, are you saying that like when you play these, you only do the romance ones?
And roll
yes.
the intro.
Yes, because why would you do anything but a dating sim?
Nope. We're gonna go ahead and roll the intro now. Okay, here we go.
Are we gonna try to read this?
Yes.
We can. I slowed down the text so it makes it a little bit easier. After stumbling into Mr. Light, one of the owners of the Witchlight Festival, the group is informed that the carnival's big top event would be starting after an hour's time.
Fine. See you there. What now?
Let's gather the others and maybe see if we can fill up this punch bowl.
Grandma, Nate, and Spada make their way back to the gnome poetry tent to find that Suntosh has been tossed out due to causing a disturbance during the show, and Balathorian has won.
I did it, everyone. I did. Guys, where's everyone?
He's muted.
Yep.
The team decides that they've had enough to do one more sideshow game and attempts to gain more punches in their card.
What do you say, Grandma? Want to wrestle some goblins?
Let us go for it. What place is that?
That's it.
Evil
Cannon.
Goblin.
Cannon. That is the official recap voice for Grandma.
That was awful. Anyways, there's a fight, and they swarm, and they're all fighting.
Wait, I thought you said you would team up against one of us.
They lied. The goblins all attack, and Grandma witnessed her little baby Nate being attacked, goes into a bloodthirsty rage, laying waste to the goblins.
Sorry.
The British one.
Stay away from my grandson.
Oh, God. Oh, the gloves. Yo, we're gonna get flagged.
It was just green goo.
After the dust had finally settled, the group receives their punches and quickly stops by a prize cart to place their spots.
Just right out.
With prizes in hand, including some pixie dust and a cool new magical hat, the team sees that the show is about to begin. So they rush to their seats within the big show's tent as the lights go dim.
Oh, yes, right.
To tonight's extravaganza, I am Mr. Light. Prepare to be delighted.
And that is where we will pick up today's session. So, as you see in the center ring of the three-ring circus that you are currently attending, Mr. Light has given a wonderful announcement, and everybody starts clapping and cheering and woo, yeah, woohoo! You see, people are excited. People are throwing, like, food and popcorn and, like, you know, everybody's cheering. And then the lights all go on. That singular light that was on Mr. Light was then relinquished to the rest of the tents. And now standing in the three rings that you see are individuals that are currently all running kind of sideshow-style things. You see in one of them that there is a large, furry, brown creature with a bushy beard, wearing overalls and a large, pointy ears protruding out of a large pumpkin that is atop his head. He has four people that he calls from the crowd to come up and sit on what looks to be a bar that has seats on the end of the bar, and each of the seats have, like, little handles next to them. The four individuals all kind of grab onto the handles as they sit down, and he grabs the middle bar and lifts them up above his head, and everybody starts cheering. You see that in one of the other ones, a strange tank of some sort, a large sphere of water, which inside you see is a giant clamshell that's being kind of wheeled out to the center ring. And then after a few seconds of silence and, like, whispers throughout the crowd, you hear, like, the sound of, like, a melody coming from the sphere. And the clamshell begins to open slowly, and inside is an absolutely stunning and beautiful blue mermaid. A large purple fin kind of runs from the top of her head down to her back, and she begins to magically serenade people through the glass. Then, there is a large tree that walks into the arena. A large tree being, like, 20 feet tall. This thing kind of, like, ducks in and moves a lot of the tent to get out of the way, and people are like, oh, like, gasping as it, like, approaches. But you see the face on this tree, and you can clearly see, Santosh especially, that there's something up with this tree. And his eyes kind of closed, his eyebrows up, he's got a smile on his face, and he's like, hey, everyone, how's everyone doing? You all having fun today?
Woo!
It's quiet.
That guy's having fun. All right. And he goes, all right, all right, all right. So, y'all want to make some wishes? All right, here we go, here we go.
Yeah, where's your stash at?
I got you, guy. Hey, thank you for cheering earlier. I really appreciate that. That's really cool of you. That was really cool of you. Okay, hold up. And he goes, and he shakes his head. And when he shakes his head, you can see giant, like, things of, like, motes of light coming from the canopy on top of his head. And they begin to drift down into the audience. A small little squirrel runs down the side of the tree. And you can see the squirrel is in kind of, like, a similar outfit to what I'm wearing right now. And he's got a little tiny top hat on.
Can I just say, the entire time, Santosh is just absolutely giggling. Like, the type of giggle that you would have if you were, like, super high and just enjoying your high.
Hell yeah.
Really, really well. He's okay. just like, oh, so this nice. Is the best high ever.
It went from the worst to the best as the little yeah. squirrel runs down the tree. And as the little squirrel comes down the tree, he jumps off the tree at the bottom and then runs over to what looks to be like a cone. You know those little speaker cones? The ones
megaphone?
That... Yeah,
megaphone,
but like it's not electric. It's just like a megaphone that you like yell yeah. into and it gets louder.
Like mm-hmm. a real one.
Like an actual megaphone. Right, sure. So it walks up to one and it has like, you know, wicked curls in it and stuff like that to make it look all like fancy and fantasy like. And it walks up to it and it speaks inside of it and it says,
make a wish! Just remember, it won't come true unless you say it out loud and for all to hear.
Oh my god.
Now, I need everyone to roll a, that's going to be a acrobatics check to see if you can snag one of these things out of the air before it lands on the ground.
Oh, thank God. Finally something I'm actually good at.
Hell yeah. Well, hell I'm not
yeah.
Dexy.
Yeah, but... I'm terrible at it, but I got a 13.
I got a 12. How am I? What is happening, man?
22.
I got a
what's absolute nonsense?
Seven yeah. plus two. I got a 9.
9.
Hey, we got a 22. How'd you even
Santo
jump
shit,
that high?
Yours is caca. That's
I jumped
that,
off
you
of
have
somebody.
Like all of like all the skill to use it, and then you still roll low enough to.
I'm a goddamn. I'm a monk.
You're always
supposed to be my thing.
Grandma rolled the best, though.
Noah, Grandma, what'd you get?
I got a 22. No,
you got 22, 22, Noah. What about Grandma? I didn't hear Grandma.
Wait, where did it go?
I saw it.
You can't find your roll,
it's
Grandma?
It's a four.
It's a four.
You can't find it because it was so small.
I'm too big to be here and I fell over the sea.
So what I'll say is that
I don't get a wish.
First and foremost, Santosh and Sfuda, you go to like capture one, and it like you guys bump into each other as you go to capture the same one.
Yo, can you not be in my way?
It like drops and floats to the ground, and then bloop, it disappears as soon as it hits the ground. Nate, when you go to grab for one, you have it in your hand. And then a tiny little child walks up to you with giant eyes, a large like lollipop to her side. And she has like, she looks like she's dressed up like a princess. She has a, like a little cone hat, that's all pink and has like little frills around it. And she just looks up at you and she begins to cry.
I'm going to look down at her and then look at the little thing in my hand. And I go, man, I sure glad you're not real or I'd feel guilty about this.
And she runs away.
Oh, no.
Noah, you are trying to see over the crowd. Every single person has jumped up and stood up and tried to jump up after these things. And you've got a face full of butt and crotch at this point. You're just trying to look around and find out what's going on. And suddenly, you see one fall through the crowd, and it's just drifting right for you. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it'll just be like a forest of legs, and then I'll like snake my way through, doing like rolls and all fours and slinking around. And just before it hits the ground, it'll be like almost like a baseball slide where I'll jump out with both hands to catch it before it hits the ground.
Okay. Grandma, you are like dead set on grabbing one. It is coming straight for you. And you just you are like slowly putting your hand up as it slowly drifts towards you. And at the last second, somebody jumps in the way and grabs it out of the air and looks at you and goes and runs away.
How do you kill him?
I know. That's what I'm saying. Just like, man, are you sure they ran away?
they ran away enough to where you can't see them at least anymore.
Fine.
Yeah. So really, certainly, out of all five of you, only two of you currently have a dandelion. It was it floated through the air, landed to your side. But again, the little squirrel speaks up. Remember.
Remember what I said? You're all looking at me really weird.
Something it's about you're a wishes squirrel. Out loud.
Yeah.
Okay.
Say your wish out loud or it won't come true.
I mean, I should just like wish for this whole thing to be over, right?
What? Nate, be careful.
Like,
I feel like
there's no place like home.
Warned us about this.
Yeah, I'm just gonna. I wish we were all back home.
The dandelion in your hand disappears.
Look around.
Nothing.
Do I? I don't know. I'm also, can I whisper it? But I gotta be out loud. So I'm gonna say.
You can say that you are saying it out loud, but also trying to keep it like to yourself. You could roll stealth. Why don't you roll stealth?
Oh yeah, I'll do that. Yeah, here I'll do that because I think I know what would come out of Noah's mouth.
Okay. What'd you get?
Okay, sure. 19 plus 3. So yeah, 22.
Okay, so you believe at least that you're pretty secretive about what you're about to say.
Okay. So I kind of like lean in and I wish I knew if it's my fault we're here. Like I just want to know if I'm the reason we're here. I want to know if I'm to blame. I just want to know that'll get. I want to find out if this is all because of me. I can't deal with. I just want to know if it's not my. I don't care. Just I can't live with. Just is it my fault?
As you're stuttering, the flower just from your hand and it disappears.
It's my fault. It was. I shouldn't have freaking got those chilies off the internet. I knew that it wasn't a .org. What kind of organization sells mystery chilies? I just.
You got your chilies from a loot crate system?
Yeah.
Like mystery chili loot crate?
Yeah.
They send
mysterychilies.org.com.
They send a bag that has a big question mark in it in the mail, and it just has a chili on it. Perfect.
Yeah, it was weird because like I had to try it like 4 times because my bank kept flagging my card and not letting it go through.
Oh my God.
And I told them, I was like, no, I'm ordering chilies. And it's just like, sir, this is coming from like a weird, like it's not in China. It's
the source
like
is off.
The in the
source,
middle of the ocean, it the says. Like the source off. Is coming from like it
the
doesn't
middle of
like,
the ocean.
It's sir, this is really suspicious. And I was like, no, I'm trying to make a jambalaya. And eventually they let it go through. I got the chilies. It took 7 months, but I got them.
That's why you really wanted to cook with them. Those are 7 month like prepped chilies. Mm-hmm. You were super excited.
They're just old.
I completely understand.
Aged. In the culinary industry, we call it aged.
Mm-hmm. Right. So with that wish, your dandelion in your hand just dissipates. The big tree in the middle has his hand like up to where an ear would be, like on his trunk, and he's like, nice. Right.
This upsets me.
Question real quick. Nothing happened.
No, nothing's gonna happen right now, at least.
When's it gonna happen?
That's the surprise, man. I don't know. This is gonna happen eventually.
Dude, trust the process, bro.
Right.
Sithara's gonna
like
lean
this guy.
Over.
He knows what's up, you know?
I got you, Green Man.
Hey,
Sithara leans
over
to Captain.
You could call me Northwind.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yo, that's a cool name, Northwind.
Right.
We're trying to get home.
I don't care, man. That's kind of like up to you how you leave the place, you know?
Be quiet, Nate. That's not it. We're looking for my grandson, Dandelion.
No, if you're looking for dandelions, you missed your chance, you know? They're on the ground. They probably disappeared by now.
Well,
you good? You look like you're having a panic attack, man.
I'm going to go console the big, hulking, crying man. Listen, you have to understand they've lost their grandchild. If we wished for an answer to a question, is it possible to get that earlier? Is if we didn't wish for something to happen, if we just wanted an answer, a yes or no, perhaps?
No, man, that's not how it works, really.
Okay, no, I was just wondering if it was possible to get it, like, expedited, if you get it, can you just tell me if it's a no or a yes, maybe, perhaps?
Sure, man, if I get a hold of it, but that's kind of not how it works, you know?
Okay, but it's possible if you get it earlier than expected.
You talk a lot, man. Nah, we're good.
Okay, all right. I'm just keep absentmindedly patting the calf of Grandma, like, it's okay.
Grandma, take your pills.
Y'all, that's a wild name, Grandma, for such a cool-looking dude. All right, well, hey, you guys have fun. Everybody, hey, you know, if you got your wish or you caught a dandelion, good luck on your wishes and everything like that. I'm out. I'll see you later. You guys can find me later if you want. I'll
what does
be
luck
chilling.
Mean?
Huh?
Dude, Tree Man. Yeah.
Yo, I'll be chilling. You guys can find me later in the, at the carnival. Like here.
Say hello to the Hobbit.
I feel like he was about to say like, follow, and subscribe.
I don't know.
He was this close to saying it.
Yeah. If you can like, follow, and subscribe to my only branch.
No.
It's not what you think. It's for art, man. It's for art.
Art.
That was a good save.
Art. Anyways.
I just want you to know that Grandma is clocking which way they leave.
Sure. No problem, man. We're gonna go now, though. Hey, little guy, come on. And you see the little squirrel, like, he leans down, and, like, the squirrel just kind of runs up his arms, and he starts to walk out of the
Well, I thought you meant that he was doing that noise to the squirrel.
Yeah, he was crunching him up, like, no.
I love that squirrel.
And I was like, whoa!
He just eats it. No, that's what he does. He grabs the squirrel and tosses him in his mouth. And the squirrel just disappears.
Okay. Whoa.
Wow.
Yeah, but the squirrel was like jumped into his mouth. All right, so, and they leave. Then, last but not least, there is a, you see that there is a colorless gray man that is almost like monotone, almost like a, like one you would see in a black and white feature film or something like that. You see him in pinstripe clothing. And he is currently miming and doing some close-up magic and entertaining many of the children. And as this happens, and as everybody, of course, is not finishing their dues, but they're like in the middle of their acts. You can still hear the mermaid singing. You can hear people cheering for the man lifting the heavy weights. Suddenly, all of the lights shut off. All of the lights in the tent shut off. And you start to hear a bunch of people whispering and like, is this part of the show? What's going on? Hey, what's going on? You hear the mermaid like cut off, like in the middle of her singing, like, hello? And
this doesn't seem normal.
Yeah. And then over what sounds like an intercom, but it is basically just like a voice that emanates through the tent. You hear, I will discover the truth behind Prismir, even if I have to tear this entire carnival apart.
All right.
Yeah, we
can
need
we
to
also
as well.
Find out the truth about Prismir?
We're in the dark, right?
It's completely dark. Everybody is like starting to panic a little bit. You hear the crowds kind of picking up.
Mysterious disembodied voice.
Who's got dark vision?
I believe I do.
I know.
I think I do.
Grandma, you'll hear from lower, like by your leg, and be like, I'm sorry, but just in case, if you don't mind, I would like basically like clamber up to like kind of be on your shoulder, like a little monkey. Like, I think people are gonna start running, and
I don't want to let you.
I don't want to be on
I've
the ground.
I've picked up like a lot of babies. Like, I'm almost like.
Oh, I mean, if you were to like reflexively try to carry me, I would just let it happen. Like, I'm just trying to be on your shoulder. But if you were to like swing and grab me, I'd be like, yeah, I think people are gonna start running, and
I really
I don't want to be down there.
I picture this being a lot like a toddler situation. Like, you're probably a little too
yes.
big for like this on the regular, but
yep.
you're definitely like a one-hander.
Yeah, there we
so
go.
You can actually sit with dignity.
There you go.
There we go.
You know what I'm
this
saying?
This is perfect.
So, okay, who
I do
first
not
off,
have
who,
dark vision.
Who, I was going to say, who has dark vision? first off.
Where would it be on my character sheet if I had it?
On the left-hand side.
Yeah, left-hand side.
Under your passive perception and the pass all under your passives.
I do not have it. Which makes sense.
60 feet of dark vision.
It doesn't make sense. I'm a robot. Who doesn't put in flashlight eyes?
You didn't install the night vision goggles.
Yeah, that is true.
You got regular, you have like 7-Eleven cameras.
Gem Dragonborns, they got night vision or no?
I don't think Dragonborns do. It doesn't seem like...
Maybe some do, I think. I think one of the Revenants or some combination of things.
So I think it's only
my Dragonborn doesn't matter.
Only
okay.
You, Noah.
So Noah, as the lights are completely out, everybody can't see it, but... all the performers are trying to like reach and they're like touching the edge of the tent and they're trying to find themselves and everything like that. But you do see Mr. Light is currently standing like in the middle of the three ring circus thingy. And he looks pissed off. And he throws his hands down to his side and he starts to march off and he opens the tent. When he opens the tent, everybody can see a shadow of him because they kind of see like the light beyond him as it closes up again. And people start to like really kind of start to like, hey, this doesn't seem normal.
And I would grab the sides of grandma's head and just point her towards it. And it's just like, light went that way. Like, just basically like,
yeah,
steer her like, yo, over here.
And
that way.
Suddenly, a kind of beam of light enters the room as someone has found the exit where you guys entered into the tent and has opened it up now. And people are starting to funnel out. And they don't seem very pleased with what just went down.
So did you say you saw where Mr. Light went?
Yeah, he was over you can't see me. I'm gonna just kind of like snap like
let's make
like,
a chain of hands.
Yeah. I would like steer grandma to kind of
everybody
collect us like a snake
purse.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to put my hand on
We
on
make a little leaving
shoulder.
The club train.
Yeah. Yeah.
I love that.
This is like the same vibe as leaving the club or like when an old person takes a bunch of kids to the store and has to cross the street.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. Both of which are happening absolutely right now. So you guys, Noah, are you leading the way then, I assume?
I'm leading the way in that I'm steering grandma, but
okay.
Grandma's
driving.
The locomotion that's leading the way.
You've got like two hands on grandma's extremely muscular thighs.
Yeah, I'm essentially on
her
shoulder. I've kind of transitioned to more
shoulder.
Of like on the shoulders type of thing.
I was like, what shape do you think we're making, Dan?
I thought you were all holding hands, so I was figuring that he was like down and like holding
that's
his
true,
hand.
But I guess
I
was just pictured like I was
hand.
Piloting like a I was Jaegering her.
Okay,
I was Jaegering.
You're ratatouing her with like
yeah.
Hairs
I assumed
on her
I was
head.
Like on shoulders, like okay, keep going this way. We're good.
Okay.
It's that way. And if like anybody's further than earshot, I can point at them. And I'd be like, stay close. Because if I whisper, I cast message into your head and you hear like the other voice more prominently, almost with the subtle tones of Spanish guitar. It's like, stay close. We're going towards it's this way. And try to keep everybody like, hey, you're going to the left. You're going too far, and keep everybody together.
All right, cool. So eventually you guys snake your way out towards the back entrance, the one that you saw Mr. Light come through or go through to leave the area. And you also, while you're making your way there, you see all the performers. They all make their way through that exit as well. And when you get there and leave out that that portion, you see you're now on the back side of the tent. It is cordoned off on like the left and the right, so people can't just come back here if they wanted to. But the thing that takes your attention away from all of that even is a gigantic, almost fantasy-like ramble of vines and everything like that that are full of like giant thorns. Think like a giant thorn wall or whatever, kind of like right in front of you. And it's about, I'd say, like 30 feet away, just like behind the tent, enough to where there's like space to walk between the two. But standing right in front of the bramble, you see a similar or a familiar face, one that you saw at the beginning of the Big Top event. You see that furry brown creature that has a pumpkin atop its head, and he's just standing there with like his arms crossed, and he's like he cracks his neck.
Is he facing us or is he looking at the thorn?
No, he's facing you. He's back to the thorns.
Sup, dude?
I think, yeah, Svada just goes up, not super close, but probably like 20 feet away, and says, excuse me, have you seen Mr. Light go this way?
He did. What are you doing back here?
He told us to come meet him in an hour. I think about an hour's passed.
Did... No one's allowed back here. This isn't for employees only.
Yes, but it was his request that we come see him.
He wouldn't make a request to come see him in the employees only area.
I mean, we are kind of the, you know, we're applying. We're kind of, we just got hired with the new employees.
What's your friend's name? That your in man.
Yeah. The guy that knew you at the beginning, because yeah. We technically are working off.
Yeah, there's we know an employee's name.
Oh, yeah. You mean Simone?
Yeah,
Simone. Oh, yeah. So, dude, Simone's back there, dude.
Yeah, Simone hired us today.
Yeah,
so we're actually employees.
He looks at you and just like squints his eyes. He goes, "Where's your employee card, then?"
Well, we just started today.
Well, so then you would have gotten your employee really card.
Simone said that we would get everything later. He said we're going to start.
Okay, go ahead and roll a deception.
Deception?
All of us?
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you want to roll like as a group or whatever, have one person roll with advantage or two people can roll.
I have plus.
I'll help. We're helping you.
Yeah. Who has the best deception?
Can I roll an intimidation? Yeah.
Deception. I have a plus +7. I mean, if we want to,
So this,
I just want to step up behind everybody and look big.
This creature stands about 7 foot tall, so he's no short stack. He's a giant woolly creature.
With a pumpkin on his head.
With a pumpkin on his
head. I rolled a 15.
I'm furry too.
And wearing overalls. You rolled a 15, Nate.
Yeah.
Okay. Is that with advantage, or did somebody want to help?
With advantage.
I thought Judy was rolling.
Judy, what did you get?
I didn't know if he was gonna whatever. Actually, unfortunately for me, I rolled a 12. It was a 5 plus 7.
Oh no!
So we'll go 15.
Okay, with a 15, let's roll his insight here. Excellent. He looks at you, and he goes.
I need to talk to Simone. Well, hold on. We need to find you a carriage.
Yeah, but before that, we got hired, and Mr. Light was like, "Yo, we need to talk to you."
Yeah.
Like, I need to talk to you, dude.
Yeah, that's fine. You can talk to him when you're in there.
Oh, wait, yeah, cool. All
right. Where do we need to go to get there?
Well, just hold your horses.
And he turns around, and he looks to his left. He looks to his right. And he kind of leans up close to the bramble.
Pixie sparkles.
And the bramble begins to form and move out of the way, creating a large entryway that was not there before. So the entryway creates almost like a nice little doorway arch. The brambles somehow move in a way that it creates almost like a wrought iron fence would be, like in a fancy graveyard or something like that. It has like that same look, but made out of brambles. And he's like,
"Well, follow me. We need to get you. Like I said, we need to get you set up."
Let me push my muscles up.
As we're walking, like Santos leans into Svara and goes, "You got that right." What was it? Pixie dust. What?
Pixie sparkles.
You say it, and the gate begins to show. And he's like, "Hey, hey, hey!"
Oh, pixie sparkles.
And it just like closes and opens and closes and opens.
Is it like a garage door opener that we're clicking to?
It is 100%. It stops halfway. And he's like, "Fuck! No, pixie sparkles." It goes up again. He's like, "Shit, pixie sparkles!" And it closes very slowly.
Dude, like, your magic door is not so magical, bro.
He's like, "Hey, it only works one way." And you weren't really supposed to hear that, but okay, whatever.
We won't tell anybody.
Yeah, I hope.
Remember, we're your new employees. Dude.
Except the Svara 100% has jotted it down in a notebook in the bag.
Yeah, it's okay. Real obvious.
Got it. So yeah, he trusts you though. He trusts you. He lumbers over to where you can now see as you enter this area. It is surrounded by the bramble, so it is just like a giant wall of bramble all around you. But you're led to a large circle of 8 wagons. There are currently just like 8 covered wagons that have like doors or, you know, sheets that are covering the front portion of each wagon. A few steps that lead up to them. Next to one of the wagons, you can see a somewhat unfriendly looking individual. You see a very large portly man. Who is dressed up in clown attire, who is basically just sitting there, and he has a pipe in his hand, and he sucks on the pipe and blows, and when he does, bubbles come out of his mouth. And he is sitting there, and he has a clown's face on that has a big smile on it, but of course, he himself has a frown. And you can, and so you are led to an area, and you are led to one of the things here. And he goes, this is for new employees. Just take your 15 minutes and then get back to work, yeah?
And yeah, when would we talk to Mr. Light?
Whenever he's ready.
As he's going away, I want to go up and say, like, real quick, the whole thing with the lights going out, was that supposed to happen, or does that happen often? Like,
no.
It seemed like he was really upset by that.
Yeah, no, it's a long story. It's not really a long story, it's just, well, Mr. Light will tell you.
Should we be worried? It seemed like everybody started to get a little worried.
No, no, guests just don't know what's going on either. It's been a long time going. This is not something new per se. That what happened was new, but other things have been going on. Like I said, just talk to him.
Okay,
you can figure it
out. Right.
Okay.
Well, thank you. We don't want to keep you from your post. We appreciate your time and just okay. And then just kind of like I'll back away awkwardly.
He pulls out a book from his overalls that he just like pulls out of his butt. Area and he just
gross.
Like not in a pocket but like through the overalls behind him and like where his
in
butt
the
is
bathroom flap
yeah like the bathroom flap he pulls it out of there and he just has this book yeah and he just starts to read it and goes back to his spot. You can hear him argue a few times with the door. He's like pixie sparkle pixie sparkles. It's like up and down
as he's like leaving. Santos yells out, yo, you got any snacks around here?
In the cart!
Oh.
Rad. I go, and Santos goes into the cart. Well,
it's craft services. Like, it's just.
Yeah, sure. It's craft services if they had no funding. So you
fair.
Go into this this area inside of your specialized cart, and it is an oversized bunk. You see that there are like 3 beds on the right, there are 3 beds on the left. You see that there's a bit of a walkway, and there's just a chest on the end of this area, and it just looks to be like a bunk of some sort.
Nice dig.
Who else is around?
Bro.
Can we clarify who, what other people
just,
are?
Just the one guy that was smoking bubbles.
I'm gonna open the chest.
You open the chest, and all that you see are uniforms of the individuals that work here. You see uniforms that people from the carnival, like carnival hands, they are wearing. They have like a vest. It's like a purple vest with gold.
Is
gold
there
lining.
An extra, 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 extra large one?
Yeah.
Two of them.
You find a robot-sized vest in there, sure.
I'm going to put it on and zip it up.
Yep.
You what do. About a giant dragonborn and a barbarian sized one?
Yeah.
Strangely enough, you find those.
Oh.
Okay.
And a tiny one.
New digs, man.
Oh,
yeah, you find
we
one.
Match like a family.
As soon as he hears that, Santos is like, smiles, and then folds it and puts it back in.
Yeah.
I'm gonna politely hold it, but never actually put it on.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, Nate, are you the only one wearing
one? Her bag.
I apparently am the only one wearing one. Okay. Because you should wear your uniforms at work.
Too, and I'm gonna hug Nate and be like, Grandma and Nate, magic.
Okay, so Grandma
now
and Nate.
Now I don't want to wear it anymore.
So Grandma and Nate, amazing. You are wearing yours. And yeah, so that's what you got. That's what you got. What else are you guys wanting to do at this point?
Well, I was wondering how long has it been since Mr. Light told us to come
see him
in an hour?
Well, it's been well over an hour. The show started in an hour. And so since the show has started, it's been probably an additional, like, I don't know, probably like 30 minutes or so.
Wow.
We're is late. Mr. Bubbles, like, it's eyeballing us or just work? There?
He was kind of eyeballing you. He did the thing where, like, he's got his head in one position and he's smoking this way and he just follows you with his eyes and slightly tilts his head as you walk by.
I'm gonna go up to him and be like, so we need to go meet with Mr. Light. We're actually already running late. Do you you know where his caravan is?
He kind of smokes on his pipe again and blows out more bubbles and he goes,
got an appointment?
Yeah, I just said that. He told us to meet him in an hour, and it's been over an hour.
Yeah, but you can't just go off of somebody's word like that.
But it's his word.
Yeah,
it's,
but it's did he give you anything or say anything like, hey, give this to Taco,
mean, we,
and then
we, yeah,
Taco
we
will,
the,
will give
did,
you
did
the,
he have a, the card?
We
have do we
the
have
full
the card?
Punch card.
Yep.
What are you, guests here? I thought you worked here. You have a vest.
Yeah, we do work here. We got them before we started today.
Wait, so you didn't cheat the games, did you?
How would we have cheated the games? We just started. We got them before we started working. We
yeah, but you're working here and you've got a full punch card. Sounds kind of fishy.
Yeah, I killed a bunch of goblins, and we got a bunch of punches.
He had a rap battle game, dude.
Yeah,
I guess a bunch of feathers on a cockatrice.
Me and my grandma killed a bunch of guys.
We weren't on the clock. It was we were like hired, but we weren't like officially orientated yet. It was a long, complicated story. We just got here. We just got our vests.
Yeah,
so the punch cards were like a previous thing. So it's like we know we're supposed to meet with him.
Right, fine. Hold on.
And he like does the old man get up out of the chair sound, and he takes his pipe and he places it down on the stump that he was sitting on, and he walks over to the cart that was nearest to him, and it looks to be a little bigger than the rest and a little bit more highly decorated than the rest, and he knocks on the door, boom 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 boom. And the little slit on the door opens, and you see little eyes kind of look up at him, and it's kind of low, and he kind of looks down, and he's like, oh,
hey, there's some people here wanting to see you.
And he's like, you hear kind of like behind the door, you hear, tell him to go away. He's like, all right.
Hey, boss ain't seeing you right now.
Can Sithara talk really loudly?
Sure.
And just be like, we're here to talk about Prismere.
And the thing closes. And he looks down and looks back up and he's like,
boss ain't seeing you.
Oh, shit, man. Well, that's rude.
Is there a door handle on the carriage?
There is.
Bubble Man?
He is standing right next to the door still. I mean, he's basically just standing in front of the door, saying like,
what
hey, boss ain't gonna have it.
What's Bubble Man's vibe? Like, is he dangerous?
He's a sad-looking clown, and he...
Oh, okay.
Well, okay, if Mr. Light won't meet with us, will Mr. Witch meet with us?
That's the first time I've laughed in weeks. No!
Why not?
Okay.
He doesn't meet with people.
Well, I mean, he's got to meet with people.
He
somebody
doesn't
talk to somebody.
Meet with people.
Where's he at? We'll go talk to him.
He's in the cart with Mr. Light.
They're both in there?
He kind of just like, you're walking up the wrong tree, buddy. You need to go. You need to leave.
Well, where are we supposed to go?
I don't care. You're working here. Just go and find something to do.
Do you know where Prismere is?
What the fuck is Prismere? No.
That's what we're trying to find out.
Yeah.
Can I point at the door? Just because it's worked already, I want to whisper through the door and message through the door at Mr. Light and say, we really need your help with this. If there's something that we can do for you, perhaps to fix this problem that is agitating you, perhaps we can help you and you can help us. And he can respond and I'll hear it.
Yeah.
If there's a response.
He does. He responds,
you better go away right now.
Okay. And wait, did he sound upset or annoyed? Like, is he upset by something and I'm catching him at a bad
time?
He's
upset by something. You're catching him at a bad time. He is not pissed that you're talking to him.
Okay. Okay. Guys, he seems really rattled by what's going on. I don't think he's not talking to us because he's necessarily angry at us, but
Okay,
I mean,
but
he's in
he's
there.
He's our only lead on Prismere.
Anyways, I'm going to get back to work.
And he sits down and he pulls up his pipe.
So he goes back into the other caravan or right outside?
Well, no, there's like I said, you're circled. It's like a circle caravan. Yeah. And if there's like, let's just say there's a campfire in the middle, he's sitting next to the campfire on a stump smoking his pipe.
He goes a few feet to the left.
Yeah, he moves a few feet to the left and sits down.
Yeah, he does. He doesn't go away. He's still watching us.
He's right. Working really hard.
He's working.
I'm going to
like approaches him and he's like, dude, can I have a puff?
I knew that was coming.
Yeah, 100%.
Yep.
He kind of looks at you. He looks at you.
Quick about it. I was going to sneak one in between.
The first time he put it down, I was like, how close is that to Santosh?
I know. Santosh has been like slowly making his way over.
He looks at you and he says, buddy, you wouldn't be able to handle it.
Dude, don't talk to me. Bro, I'm on the biggest high right now and I'm handling it like a champ.
Then you don't want to stack it. Just saying.
Dude, come on. Dude. Don't be like that. Don't be one of those haters out there, dude.
Roller persuasion check.
Oh, no.
Why? Persuade him with your muscles. I don't know.
Look at me, dude. I'm like 7 feet tall, right?
Yeah, he's also a giant sav clown.
No, he's not giant. He is only like 5'4".
Yeah, like sometimes he's like peering down. I'm like, dude, come on, dude.
Are you trying to bully him?
I'm not pestering. It's not even bullying. It's
cyber bullying.
Peer pressure is not okay.
You want me to do a persuasion again?
Hell yeah. Did you roll already?
No, I did not.
Yeah, go for it. Roll.
It's a 12.
Hey, that's not bad. Let me roll his...
All considering.
Yeah. Actually, with his three...
I've created one of the most broken characters I've ever played.
With his three, he does not succeed. So he looks at you and he goes... He looks over. He looks back and forth.
Your funeral...
Ah, dude.
Any hands
much
to you.
Appreciated. I take a, and then Santos is like, he takes it, and then he takes a big.
Whoa!
And he like reaches up and like tries to grab it from you.
Fails.
You have it up above.
And as he blows out, I'm assuming just like a big bubble.
One big bubble instead of like a series of bubbles. One big bubble comes out.
You're dead.
I just saw
it.
Like those like people on the beach with the string and they make like a bubble the size of a bus.
Yeah, yeah. Santosh, I mean, your lung capacity as a dragonborn is through the roof comparatively
legendary.
To your human
and
self.
Experienced.
Exactly. So with those two things combined, a giant bubble comes out and you can see like the most
can
worried...
I make it into a shape?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Oh, that,
I hope
go
that
for it, Gandalf.
Like, little static electricity is like those the ball at the side.
Oh yeah,
of his
he does have
where, like you
breath,
put your hand
too.
On
that's
it
the other
and,
thing.
Like...
When it comes out.
So yeah.
I have I okay, you know what I wanted this to do? All right, this just came to me. I breathe it out.
Yeah.
And whether intentionally or unintentionally, the bubble blows out in the direction of Mr. Light and Mr. Witch's caravan.
Okay.
And it looks harmless because it's a bubble.
I can see where this is going.
Mm-hmm.
I have thunder breath.
Sure do.
And so when it blows out, it literally is containing a bubble of thunder breath that is going towards that door.
Oh my god.
How many times a day can you cast that, or is that just
two times?
I've used
it once, yes, and now this is my second.
Okay.
I think this is worth it.
Okay.
Yes. Absolutely.
So he's like, no. And Santosh,
can I have it in the shape of a dragon?
Like, you can absolutely Gandalf the hell out of this thing. It comes out of your mouth looking like a dragon or whatever.
Grandma's like, that's the coolest smoke ring I've ever seen. Yeah.
You look like fucking SpongeBob in that one episode blowing like shakes through the bubbles.
I was about to say, I was like, when was SpongeBob getting high as hell smoke doing smoke tricks?
Like every episode, Junie, what were you watching? Exactly.
So you blow the bubble, but Santosh, you do what you say you do. That's fine. You can add the magic to it, and we can have the effects and everything like that.
Okay.
But suddenly the world begins to shift and move in front of you. The world looks like a wavy picture, kind of like going up and down, almost as if like heat marks on everything, causing colors and things to swirl. Every single person you look at right now looks like a bubble person.
What?
They are just made of bubbles.
You see Santosh come up to Swara and just start poking her. Like,
oh. To you, the bubble just like bends in a little bit.
Swara just smacks Santosh's hand away. What are you doing?
Santosh, this is like...
Dude, you look so cool as a bubble.
Santosh. Aside from the times that you've been absolutely so gone that you just passed out, this is like the most high you've been while awake.
Oh my god, this was a
mistake. I've never been high on a high.
You see that he's inspecting the pipe like, what the hell?
Ladies and gentlemen, my brother is an idiot.
What happened to the bubble?
What did happen to the bubble, Santosh?
Oh, well, it was making it, he was pointing it in the direction of the thing, and whether or not, so this is KP, not the intention of Santosh, but the intention of KP.
Okay.
In that bubble in the shape of a dragon hits that door and then basically blows open the door.
Okay. Well, I don't know. We'll say that it definitely has an effect on the carriage, but it won't blow open the door.
At least shakes it in a manner that forces them out.
100%. So the bubble goes out in the shape of a dragon. You are high as balls, and everybody else kind of is like looking at you. You see concerned bubble faces on their faces. And then suddenly, the thing rocks, and Taco goes, uh-oh. Ah! And he walks over to the door, and the door swings open. And instead of the tall Mr. Light that you are familiar with, you see a new individual in front of you. Hmm. You see a kind of shorter, more portly individual, gray skin, much darker gray skin than Mr. Light has. Very dark gray skin. You see that this individual is wearing a kind of like a bowler's cap, I believe, is his general vibe. He has a top hat on. So you see he has a top hat on. He has like a rose right on the top of his top hat. He's wearing a coat that is like plaid that goes down to his knees. He has a large rose that is basically like a huge, what are they called? Like corsage? Like those things?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, corsage.
Yeah, that huge rose thing right there. You see he's wearing a like a velvet a crushed velvet what are these things? Vest, and he has a pinstriped pantsuit on. And he looks at you and he's got a very grumpled face on. He's like, "Hey, who was that?"
Did you say grumpled? I just want to double check and make sure.
That's what I said.
Okay.
It's grumpy and crumpled.
That's how bad it is.
Crumpled because okay. he's so
it's
grumpy.
Grumpled.
I'm gonna look at the clown.
The clown is like,
Mr. Witch. I point at him and the pipe.
Yep.
Dude, gave me a pipe, dude.
Mr. Witch, I'm sorry. I don't know what happened,
that was
but
the best hit ever.
New employees here.
Puff that all day, dude.
I don't care who they are. What are you doing to the cart?
Does he come out or does he just open the door?
He just opened the door. He's in the doorway.
Well, we really need to talk with you and Mr. Light.
And he goes, what for?
Well, we're trying to get to Prismere.
His face kind of like backs up. He like his head backs up as he like hears the word.
Where'd you hear that word?
Well, so there was a guy in a swamp. And he told us that we need to rescue his patron, Zabilna, from Prismere. And that...
Hey!
What?
What get inside. Happened? Get inside.
Ah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, all right.
Okay. Hey. Taco!
As everyone inside, I'm going to go, didn't somebody just like over a loudspeaker say something about Prismere? Like as we're going to, because they did just say it like to the public.
Yeah.
So the name is like apparently should be common knowledge now. And so it's like, what do you mean? Why is he saying like nobody knows this word now? Is this a secret
get
word
inside,
we should know?
Stop talking.
Santo's just like walking, but definitely swaying. And then you see him like.
Yeah.
you run into Svara the door frame.
Has a hand on Santosh's elbow.
Okay. Okay.
This is not the first time she has had to guide
yeah.
her brother in sure. locomotion.
Yeah, absolutely. So,
you're so
he kind of like he looks both directions as you all enter the little cart, and he looks both directions and he Taco.
God, the entrance here. Don't let anybody in.
And he's like,
be careful with
Taco.
Those bubbles, son.
And he just like, lays back and goes back to smoking bubbles.
I was reading everything from my notebook, so I'm checking back through my notes as I'm walking in.
Okay. And you walk in, and you can see a very disgruntled Mr. Light. But Mr. Light, you saw his face before. It was painted white. He has like a red diamond on it. And he's got like he's very eccentric with his motions and everything like that. And he had a cool looking like cane that he carried around. It was like a short cane. Mm-hmm. You can see the cane that is like leaned up against the wall. And he looks up as he's kind of just sitting there. He looks up from between his knees. And when he does, you can see he's been crying. His makeup is like running down his face. He's like, "What are you doing here?"
Well, we ran into you earlier.
Yeah, I know who you are. I didn't say, who are you? I said, what are you doing here?
You promised us a conversation.
I told you to go away, specifically, right now.
Yeah, but before
dude,
you had promised us a conversation.
Don't talk to my sister that way, bro.
Yeah, we have things to talk about, and we need to talk about them so we can go home.
Have a seat. Have a seat.
I'd want to just... kind of like get a little closer and go, what's wrong?
Well, like I said, have a seat. So once you take a seat, then we'll get started.
And he pulls out from his vest a golden like watch that's like mm-hmm. has a little chain attached to it, and he pops it open and he closes it and puts it back in his coat.
Look, Prismere, you said Prismere.
Yeah, and looking at my notebook, and Zabilna.
Yeah, whatever. But Prismere specifically, where did you hear that name?
It was a wizard in a swamp.
In the Swamp of Sorrows.
Swarrow Swamp.
Yeah, okay. So you heard it from a swamp.
No, the wizard.
No, we
in the
heard
swamp.
It from a wizard in the swamp. But the important thing is, we need to get there, and we were told you would know how we can get there.
Well, I don't know who would have said that I know how to get there.
And you hear Mr. Light go, "No, well, maybe. Hold on." And he looks at you. And he's like, he sniffs.
There's been some person or something that's been affecting everything here at the carnival. You could tell by whatever happened there at the Big Top event.
Yeah, the big voice. Ominous voice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Talking about Prismir.
Yeah. I don't know how they know about Prismir too, but I don't know. Anyways.
It does not seem to be a well-kept secret. I'm sorry to say.
I really just thought that it was like everybody knew about this place.
Nobody
like
knows about Prismir. So it's okay. Strange.
Except all of us.
You. I don't know how, but anyways, look. I think it's a Kenku doing it all.
A Kenku?
Yeah, Kenku.
Like,
large,
and,
like bird. Can,
the bird?
I was like, can Svara do a history check to know if she knows Kenku the race in D&D?
You can roll a history check.
Doesn't she have the book on her?
Oh, I do have, but no, it's not in the player's guide, player's handbook, is it?
No, it's not. It is in a supplemental material.
But Svara has watched actual plays.
You have.
That is, however, only a 9.
I am inundated by Dan Danielson with all things
true.
D&D.
Nate, I would say, just in like inadvertently probably knows about
okay.
Kenku.
Nate knows whether he wants to
Kenkus can only repeat what they've heard.
Yeah.
So he's heard about Prismir.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
I know you think we don't talk about Prismir, but I think we all talk about Prismir.
Yeah,
here.
We're talking a lot about
no,
it.
No, nobody knows. It's secret.
You're
I think everybody
spread,
knows.
Wait.
Secret
means something different here? I want to make sure I'm not crazy.
You're all upsetting him. Just, hey, come on.
Sorry.
And okay. He kind of walks over to
you
him.
Just
and
hear,
he
you
puts
just
his
hear
hand
up. Under his breath goes, we don't talk about prison. We don't talk
Damn
about
it.
Prison.
And he puts his hand on Mr. Light's he puts his hand on Mr. Light's shoulder, and he kind of places his hand on his other shoulder, and he places his head down. He's like, it'll be all right. You need to calm down. You need to calm down. And he's like, no, calm down. When that Kenku pest is gone.
Dude, you need
is
to dad,
the Kenku from Prismir?
Look. I don't know where she's from or how she got that information. Look. She knows nothing, all right? She'll get frustrated enough and be on her way eventually.
Is she, so she's here?
Yeah, she's been messing with the carnival. She's been messing with the carnival for a while now.
I understand that, but we're here to figure out how to get to Prismir. The Kenku is neither here nor there.
No, that is not true. The Kenku is here because I might know how to get to Prismir. But that's secondary. What you need to do is you need to help me with this pest problem.
We can,
okay.
I believe we can.
Oh,
help
okay.
Yeah.
So we're talking about a
yes.
quid pro quo.
Yes. Yeah. We will find this Kenku and bring them here and prevent them from.
No, no, no.
Any,
no. No, you need
no?
to just get rid of them.
Oh, damn. Okay.
Like, have them
leave the carnival, like. Ban
you
them?
Do.
Do you want to hand a banned letter saying perhaps you are no longer welcome here?
You can do whatever you want to do as long as they're gone and they don't come back.
Okay. So we can evacuate the Kenku because at least I am not an assassin for hire. But we can evacuate the Kenku.
I don't know what evacuate means, but sure, you can leave.
Just get them away from here and no longer be in your problems and making your problems happen, right? So it's just no longer here.
Uh-huh.
You want them gone.
Yeah.
And then you will perhaps help us.
Perhaps. You will.
I just want to not force it on him. I just want.
I'm forcing it on him
okay.
because
yeah. So
he
you're gonna,
promised to talk to us in an hour
us,
and then
you're
said
gonna fucking
no.
Tell us what we need
whoa,
to know.
Whoa, whoa,
that's right.
Whoa.
There it is.
I had already told you that I was gonna tell you. There's no need for hostilities.
We just wanted to be sure.
Hey.
We've been all over the place. And
you changed your mind once.
We wanted to make sure that we're
on the same
page.
I didn't know that you were able to help out in the situation. I was losing it a little bit, and I'm going a little wild in my eyes.
I'm
going
to tug at Grandma. I'm going to tug at Grandma and just say, lemon bar, lemon bar, lemon bar.
Mr. Oh, Witch.
Smutta is pulling at Santosh's arm to be like, do you have more of that stuff? I think he needs some.
Everybody's trying to dose him. Everybody's trying to medicate the
mood. Mr. Witch walks up.
First thing.
Mr. Witch walks up to him, Mr. Light, when he's kind of going off the chain, and he goes and gives him a big old hug.
Yeah, Santosh was about to do, actually. Santosh kind of was like, dude.
Still
do it. Santosh comes down and just hugs both of them.
Mr. Witch sees you coming in for the hug and just, like, face palms you away.
Oh, no. This is happening. This is a hug that's happening.
He's getting his face mushed, and he's still going in for it.
Yeah. Still getting in there and hugging.
Dude, it's cool, dude. It's all cool.
Let it happen. Just let it happen.
Okay.
You're right. I see. Yeah, you're right.
He's like, all right, get off. He's like, hey, you're going to be just fine, all right? Just keep your calm. They're going to help us, all right? Hey, look at me. We're going to be fine. He's like, I hope you're right.
Do you know where, like generally the Kenku would be?
He kind of just looks at you and he goes, wherever trouble is going down. Pretty simple.
That's
super unhelpful.
Vague. She's a prankster, mm-hmm. I guess. I don't know. She keeps fucking shit up here.
Okay. We'll go figure out where some stuff is happening.
Wait. Before we go.
Yeah.
We had a bit of a hard time getting to you last time.
Uh-huh.
Someone mentioned something about a card we could have that can get us through to you. Don't want to have to go through all of that again.
He kind of looks around. He's like, well, here. Just take this. And he hands you a card, and it's just literally a ace of diamonds.
Okay.
That's a wicked cool card, dude.
Thanks.
Goes right into the bag.
Yeah.
Lost forever.
I got him printed out.
I'm sorry. Nothing is lost in that bag. There's pouches within pouches within pouches.
Organized.
Things are labeled.
Labeled, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Label maker labels inside of
it's
a purse.
Also, it's like one of those heat label makers, so you don't even need, like, ink or anything.
Yeah, I was going to say, it has to be special to stick to the lining of the inside. Yeah, that's got to be a thing.
Okay. All right. He goes, well, whatever you want to do with it, that's fine. Just show him this card. It should be okay.
All right.
Well, get rid of her for me now. Go.
Well, okay. And as we're going, I'm gonna like slap my hand onto Santosh's back and be like, "You all right, buddy?"
Oh, dude, I'm seeing sounds, dude.
I'm not super sure how helpful that is.
We
I'm
need
like,
to get
I'm
him
like
some
bat.
Food.
And
hand him a
and as
more.
I'm like
no.
Talking, as I'm talking to him and, like, looking at him, I want there to be, like, kind of the smell of, like fresh ocean wind, stuff like that. And then using my 5 points of lay on hands without meaning to cure him of poison. Or neutralize a poison that's affecting him.
Okay. So Santosh, it might not affect weed, but whatever the hell was in that thing would definitely be considered some kind of poison. Nate, what does it look like when you use your lay on hands?
It's kind of like I said, that kind of the smell of the ocean.
Yeah.
And then like kind of like a light blue glow.
Okay. So a light blue glow, almost as if like you're putting your hands, you have like black lights in your hands and they sterilize whatever they go over. Santosh, he does that and suddenly the waviness of everybody goes away. And their bubble forms pop. But inside the bubbles are their regular selves.
I can't wait for the bubble fan art. Like, all the bubble versions of all of us. This is going to be so cool. All
right. But yeah.
Oh, dude, what happened to my eye?
His father's right. We need to go get you some food.
We need food. Let's get some food and let's go find a whatever that is.
Just go. You've been standing here for quite some time.
Oh, we were
now.
Walking and talking, I thought.
Oh, no. You've been standing here the whole time.
Okay, we're going.
We
got closer to the door every few, like, we'd take a few steps, talk for like 20
monologuing.
Minutes. Yeah.
Listen,
you can't leave a relative's house.
We are working on our Sorkin. It's a process.
Got it. On your way out the door, Mr. Witch. He does that thing where he like leans out the door and he's like hanging on to the door, like a little bit further out of the doorway, and he like looks at you and he goes, "Hey, hi, come here."
To who?
To whoever's listening.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure, we all do it.
Yeah. Okay. All five of you. I don't give a shit. Whatever. And he goes, "Hey, you take care of this Kenku. Like, take care of this Kenku." Give you an extra 20 gold pieces.
Is that a lot of gold pieces?
That's it?
Grandma, roll
like
a persuasion check.
Not assassins for hire.
Just feels cheap.
Grandma was already an assassin for hire.
Well, no, and Svara has only watched high-level campaigns, so she just like, 20 gold?
I rolled 2 times, but I didn't roll good either time, so 8.
He goes, "Hey, I don't have to offer you nothing. Look, just help us out then.
We don't have to kill this bird."
He goes, "I don't care how you do it, but if you do it and you do kill him, maybe you find some gold in your pockets. Who knows?"
Is it?
So you're saying 25 each?
No, I said 20 gold, the exact words that came out of my mouth.
Maybe we keep the bird as a pet.
No.
That's a person.
Santosh, you can also roll
a
persuasion.
Yes, it's a person that he wants us to murder.
I mean, but none of this
persuasion?
You need to roll persuasion.
This is real.
Persuasion. That's a 15.
Nice, okay. And he goes... He looks back. You can see him look back at Mr. Light. And Mr. Light is crying. And he's like, "Fine. 20 gold pieces each."
Hey. My man.
Get out of here. Go.
God, he's clutch one.
And he shuts the door.
Before he does that, Svara try to get a read on him?
Yeah,
you
want to try and
steal?
Roll an insight check?
Yes,
kind of read the situation?
Yeah. Let's try digital dice, because the physical one is not being my friend today. Oh, not to a virtual tabletop. 16.
That's a 16.
Yeah.
Not bad. Okay. So, you'd probably be able to tell that he cares a lot for Mr. Light. And that... He just wants the problem solved permanently without the thought of this person returning and doing the same thing to Mr. Light again.
Okay. Well, that's
adorable. Probably what you would glean from this.
Ride or die.
By the way, I had a question from earlier,
if
possible. In the state that he was in, yeah, back then, I feel like Santosh would be just, like, messing around and touching things and holding on to and playing with stuff.
Yeah, you would have.
Is there or were there anything of particular interest that I would have picked up on in that state? Something, say, magical or cool or interesting.
Are you talking about
inside
the
carriage while
in the carriage?
There. Yes.
Roll an Arcana check.
Oh. Well, I don't have anything in particular. That is a nat 20!
What? Nat 20! Very nice.
Amazing.
It's been a while since I've seen nat 20 pop up on this screen. I'm down.
It's been a while since I've ever gotten anything close to that. So
let's see. I don't know why my nat 20 isn't working. It's a very sad day, but nat 20. That is a nat 20. Okay, friends, nat 20.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so with that, Santosh, you would have known that the cane that Mr. Light was carrying slowly spun at its top. You could see
it. Oh, I definitely had grabbed it then.
Hold on. First off. Jeez. And second off, you note that Mr. Witch's watch that he pulled out seemed quite magical indeed, because he didn't push anything or do anything. It opened up on its own and then closed and then put it back in his
yes, chest. But the cane was on the side, put to the side, and
well,
it was
next to Mr. Light, like kind of just leaned up against
when the I was hugging him, I would have seen the cane.
Okay, so you try to snatch the cane from
absolutely. Okay. It looked cool.
So go ahead and roll a sleight of hand.
It didn't seem malicious. I think he's just like, he was talking about like, hi, like, what's this? He picks up a pen, still, puts dude. It down. What's this? He picks up a slipper, puts it down. You know what I mean? So I think he's just picking crap up.
So you're not taking it.
Well, I
think he would keep it if it looked dope enough.
Well,
I think
you're making
intent.
An argument for him to say he was just taking it and leaving it.
I got a nat 20 again.
What the fuck?
Oh,
you give him the damn cane, Dan. Don't you take this cane from him?
This is fucking garbage. What is this shit? Hey, let's go back in time and that thing that seems super important. Yeah, I steal it.
Dan is like, I quit, bye.
Well, you described it. You described it in the scene. It was there. The scene played out. We didn't see it the rest of the scene, and we're seeing it again magically in his hands, and we didn't realize that he took it. Yeah, he just
a very good sleight of hand.
Sure. Okay.
It was nat 20 good.
He slided too so well, we didn't see it at the time until we were out of the room.
He did it
and
out of the game.
And now we're outside, and he doesn't even know why he has it.
No, but you're right, Dan. Let's punish the natural 20.
Hey, how about you shut your mouths and let's just continue on with whatever I say. So, yeah, you steal it. You steal it.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh. All right. Does he realize what he's done when
you're
outside?
You have walked outside, and as you're walking away, Santosh, you, like, start to, like, toss it up in the air and play with it. Like,
yeah, I'm just like, walking around with it, like,
oh my god,
like unconsciously.
It is way too small for you. it's a cane that like.
Where
is a baton?
Bro, are you doing the Panic at the Disco dance?
Dude, yes.
So okay,
oh
this
god,
cane,
I knew
this
you
cane
would.
Is only like maybe this tall. So like, it's.
I saw you
using
like a wand.
Yeah, it's like 3.5 foot tall. Like, let's say the cane is about 3.5 foot tall.
Is it taller or shorter than Noah?
My size.
It is. It is about your size. It is about Noah's size.
It's a bow staff for me.
So, for reference, this is the look of the thing that you're holding. So it's like in his hand. You can kind of barely see it, but
it's got a. Like butterflies.
So it's got a butterfly on the top, right? But the butterfly is a thing that was spinning around, right? Slowly spinning around. So anyways, you pull it out of your butt, wherever you were holding it.
No, but I have my robe, and I was like in the robe.
Okay,
like,
so you pull it out of your robe.
Did you steal that?
No, I was playing with it.
Santosh, in your
He's
head.
Probably not gonna miss it.
Santosh, in your head, you hear, hey, who are you?
What?
You? Who are you?
To Nate, I'm gonna go. I think you need to do it again. I think he's. I think he's still. I think he's still
like,
got the stuff.
Okay. Yeah. Let's go get you. Let's go get you some food, and we'll get you. We'll get you. Nobody hears it. You're really high. Let's go get you some food.
We all need
a bar.
You're quite handsome too.
Oh, thank you, dude.
Who are you talking to?
Who are you?
Can I speak to it in my mind?
Yeah, you can speak
like,
back
if I were to think it.
Yeah, you think back to it, exactly.
Yeah. I'm like, sup, dude? Thanks. Who are you?
No, me. I'm the cane.
And some of those are kind of just staring at the cane.
Yeah, that's me. I'm the cane.
Are you... right, who's
you seem a bit confused. I'm assuming you've never held a magic wand or a magic cane?
No. I mean,
No, that would be a no.
No, not really. But dude, this is so cool. I have a talking cane.
Your friends are looking at you quite weird.
Did he say I have a talking cane out loud?
This is all in his head.
This is all in the head.
Okay.
But he has been staring at his fucking cane like this, like in front of him, like.
Yeah, like
I imagine gonna, I'm just miming. Like,
so
everything.
I will shake him.
Nothing. It was nothing. What? And then you see Casantos walk off.
Oi! Don't walk away from me!
Auntie Sputta comes out.
Carry the don't walk away from me!
And as you are walking away, we'll go to our break. We'll go take a break. All right.
Did I break your game already, Dan?
No, you didn't. I mean, you kind of did. Girl's
in trouble, though.
But it's fine. It's fine.
You're going to pay for that.
It's not broken yet. So don't worry.
It's fine. I'm just going to go cry. That's why I'm taking a break.
I told you guys, do crazy stuff and we'll play it, we'll roll with it kind of stuff. That's kind of what the whole vibe is of this stream. So that's one of the things. You just stole the super important magical item. Don't worry about it.
The end game.
It's not going to come back to bite us in the ass.
I thought we were going to fight Mr. Watch, so I put my hair back. I was ready. I was like, oh, we're about to fight this guy.
I need to grab dinner. So
we'll go on break. I will see you guys here in about 5 or 10 minutes. We'll say 10 minutes. We'll be back in 10 minutes, and we'll see you here in a little bit. Bye, guys.
See you in a bit.
Bye.
Are we?
Yep, we are audio live. Don't forget.
All right.
You just mute yourself. If you.
I did not expect any of that to happen.
Dude, you doubled nat 20. Like, holy
shit. I've been failing so many rolls consistently.
I was actually impressed.
That was probably the two best rolls I've ever had.
I love that shit. That was funny.
Unreal.
Actually, KP, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna send you the stats of this thing. Now, Santosh wouldn't know this, but so I don't have to remember to send it to you, again.
Okay. Where are you sending it?
I'll probably just send it to Discord. Probably easiest.
Secret post. Mind message.
Just making sure this is the actual one. I think it is. Okay, I'm just going to send you the website that has it on it.
Is it something that can be provided in our D&D Beyond?
I don't know. It might be created in D&D Beyond as an item.
I mean, considering that the Witchlight setting now should be in there, right?
It should be, yeah. Maybe. But the thing is I don't think it's supposed to be in your hands. So I don't think maybe they didn't make it. Hold on, let me I'm gonna search it up, see if I can find it.
That'd be amazing. And I feel like there's also ways to just homebrew it, or not homebrew, but like you can create your own.
Yeah, you can make your own items.
Things, so. If I have the stats and stuff, or if you have the time and want to, you can create a magic.
Okay,
item.
So it is.
It's in there!
It is. So I don't know how it works, though, for you being able to put it in your.
Your let's daily see. Diet. Okay, so let me. If I do this.
Unmade!
What?
Unmade Gaming just raided.
Oh, hey! Buddies! I just to catch you all up, I got high and broke his game. And so we're on break, so that way Dan can figure out what the hell he needs to do next, because clearly we are.
We gotta make a new game now.
We're basically making a brand new game.
No, all right of now. This is a farce.
I literally just got the end game item as a level 1 character, so, you know, It's like if you were playing any of the Final Fantasy games or like Kingdom Hearts games, and you got the what is it, the Oblivion Key? No, not the Oblivion Key. The Ultima Weapon.
Yeah.
On like in the first tutorial level.
Hey, this will be fine. This will be fine. Be great. You know why? Because first of all, we're professionals, right? We know how to use all this shit. We know.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
We definitely know even our own abilities, like. To the full extent of their, you know, yeah.
Okay, yeah. That was convincing.
This is gonna hurt us real bad at all. No, not even. This isn't like a bunch of kids getting a chainsaw.
No.
Yeah, professional streamer. Anyways, welcome in everybody from Unmade Gaming. If you don't know, my name is Dan Munoz. I'm the head runner here of Not One Fun, and this is Running Feywild. We play every Wednesday. You can catch
every
us
every other
live.
Wednesday now.
Every other Wednesday, you're right. Thank you very much for reminding me. So every other Thursday, you can catch us at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, and we usually play for about like two and a half hours or so, and then you can check us out like here on this channel on Not One Fun. I have other shows like on Monday we do a fully improvised TTRPG show where we spend about an hour or so completely improvising a TTRPG scenario and playing off of it.
Mm.
And then on Saturdays we have our Icewind Dale campaign. You can catch them. Their Icewind Dale campaign should be coming to an end probably here within the next few months.
Oh, shoot. Not to mention, if you like any type of isekai shows, this is the one for you.
That's true.
Do you like regular people being thrust into a fantasy setting where they have no clue what's going on and now embody a brand new avatar, and now are absolutely OP because somehow he stole a goddamn magical staff just 10 minutes ago? Well, there you go. That's your show for you right now. Stick around. It's gonna get chaotic.
So, it's funny. It is a very broken item, but they have a way of solving this issue, which I think is pretty funny. But not in the way you think. You are welcome to do whatever you'd like with it, but yeah.
Two nat 20s. Nat 20s. I don't even remember when I last rolled a nat 20, okay? And to have that happen two times.
So
for this
he was like
scenario too.
He was like, "Hey, we were just in that thing, that little place, you know, together. Did I see anything while I was in there?" I was like, "Oh, roll to see." Nat 20. Okay, well then you definitely saw these things. He's like, "Okay, can I have like maybe snuck it away or grabbed it while they
I
were
was
looking?"
I was just high and I wanted to play around.
I'm
things,
like,
right?
"Sure, why not? Another nat 20." Let me grab the main NPC's weapon or item and walk away with it.
Yay. Best day ever.
Double nat 20s.
Listen, okay, Mike from Unmade Gaming here would know and tell you that I don't do well with rolls, all right? Particularly on roll 20. Roll 20 and I do not get along. Does not like roll 20. Wants to see me fail. Insists on me failing.
It does.
So
it does.
It is ruthless.
That's how it's made. I think that's in the algorithm.
Yeah, and no. It's in the algorithm for me because apparently I'm the only one. Frickin'
oh no, that's what I meant. It's only
It's written KP fails.
Yeah.
Hashtag KP fails.
Your IP address.
If you view source roll 20.
Mm-hmm,
your
mm-hmm.
picture's in that. Under
failed.
Like an ASCII art.
I was
going to
say, you hit F12, it's ASCII art, KP.
It's just like,
but it's like,
bullshit.
It's one of those ASCII arts where you scroll for like 15 minutes and then like it's animated.
Oh, God.
It's
me
rolling
KP.
A dice and then just hands in my face. In my,
it's KP,
in my...
but in the Rickroll music video.
So I mean, it took a while to program that, but I think they believe it's definitely worth it.
So
now
like,
having
you
roll
work on that.
terrible rolls your whole time in existence.
The cost of the hair and the beard, I suppose. But yes, so to have this win today, you don't know what it means to me.
It might not be a win.
It's
listen, I'll take the tiny iota that I get, whether it turns into utter chaos and is the beginning of our doom. That is a future KP problem. Current KP is ecstatic. Let me have this, man. Let me have this, okay?
Dan, he's definitely not gonna hurt himself.
Okay, say that out loud, please.
Or us.
Hey, Kobe, thank you very much for the follow. Welcome in.
I gotta push my muscles up for this.
You need to make sure those pecs are right where they belong on your shoulders.
Like right under, busting up against my Adam's apple.
Yeah. I'm just imagining
your
like
pecs don't do that. Like that's what my pecs
do. That's where they are. That's
I have trouble breathing sometimes because my pecs are so big and they obscure my breathing.
That's true about Dan.
It just hurts your back, you know. Little?
Yeah, they do. Don't. He has to wear a bra.
A brassiere.
Brassiere. Yeah.
Metallic brassiere.
I like to call it a bro.
Can our super brassiere. Manly, super barbarian person get a magical item that is absolutely OP, but is just the most scantily clad?
Oh, yeah, for sure. It's going to be like crocheted bikini. It's going to be a crocheted bikini.
Our big bad buff dude.
For our badass, yep, buff dude barbarian. And it's gonna take like a lot to not see a lot of dong while he's fighting, you know what I mean? Because it's just gonna be there is absolutely no way that it's gonna be able to cover all of the goodies while in the middle of a fight. But it gives like plus 10 to armor.
Oh, I didn't get a chance to look at the item.
Oh, I was about to say, did you get it? Sorry, I didn't even think about it.
No, I got it. I just haven't. Oh.
And while we're on break, have fun and watch our Patreon ad, please. And thank you.
Patreon.com/runningfeywild. Look, this show ain't free to make. We all know that. And what's the best way you can help me and the team out so we can put food on the table? Yup, Patreon. With several different tiers of support starting only at $3 a month, what is that, like a few chicken nuggets? You gain access to a ton of cool shit like inserting your own NPCs, locations, magic items, and wild magic surges into our game. Or sign up for our top tier and get a one-on-one with me monthly where we go over the campaign and everything D&D. By throwing your cash at the screen, you not only get that other cool stuff, but you get Patreon exclusives such as our soon-to-be merch, early access to podcast episodes, and tons of behind-the-scenes goodies.
Fair enough.
No, so run on over to our Patreon today and sign up.
I'm the worst one here tonight. I'm me. I'm the one that works in a library. I'm the one that's the most dangerous, edgy. I'm that guy. I'm that one that needs to be flagged on every play.
No.
God damn it, Judy. You gotta calm down with this.
Yeah, I think it.
There are
I
children watching.
I think the charismatic kobold's coming through.
Oh, I love that accent. Every time I hear it, I just smile. It's the best. Ugh.
It's fun.
It's the best. Can I just say that this staff is both my worst and best friend. It's like my worst enemy and my best friend. Because let me tell you, as a bludgeoning tool, it is fantastic. As what it's intended to be, which is a magical item to help cast magical things, it is not, because it literally requires charisma, which is my worst stat.
Give me that, right? Give it to me or Junie right now.
Nope, mine.
I really like where it's at right now. I don't know why, but I'm thinking
it's okay. We need to steal freaking Pooja's hat that she got that also gives plus to charisma.
Mm-hmm.
Giving it to all the non-charisma people.
Just make me more charismatic.
I'm just gonna go beat up Mr. Witch for his watch now. This world doesn't matter anymore. It's not real. I'm a robot. What's he gonna do?
I'm a freaking robot. What's
I'm
he gonna
a robot.
Do?
That's so funny because you're I not, but you're like, I'm a robot. I don't care. It's like, what? But you're not a robot, right? I mean,
no, I'm phasing.
Punch me in the face. So
I'm phasing into that.
You better hope you don't have a magnet.
Put it on my head, I'll just start singing.
Oh, I get that. That's good.
This needs just needs a can opener. That's gonna be your worst nightmare.
How do I add this? I need to add this. The manage inventory.
Did y'all like my like Cheech, or I guess he was more Chong. Did you like my Chong?
I thought you were going for one. I think you might have switched at some point because there was a split second. I was like, oh, is he going for... Oh, never mind. Wait, hold on. Yeah.
Mr. Like Light's it. Mr. Light's still my favorite.
Nah, man. Nah.
Hey, Dan.
Yeah, what's up?
I noticed something real quick while I was checking my 11,000 nat 1 gold. That somebody has removed the switch face option. Yeah. Why would you do that?
Because I can't get it to work with my camera. Can't get it to work with my camera right now.
I'll have you know, I'm gonna go ahead and just spend all 11,000 on spamming one thing over and over again.
Please, yeah, make me drink myself to death. Or stretch until I die. Yes, stretch
you only
until
have
I die.
Stretch and posture check, which are the same thing.
Stretching could just be doing like arm circles or just arm things. He's not doing his posture.
Everyone, get in here!
Oh, snap. Hold on. What else did we have here? Sugar Axe, raiding with a party of four. Welcome in, Sugar Axe, and welcome in, crew. We're actually coming back right now, so just right on time. Welcome in, everybody. Welcome to Nat 1 Fun.
Hey.
And welcome to Running Feywild. Let's give a proper welcome here as we come back. Nope. I hate that.
Not at all.
I keep forgetting the
proper
welcome thing off. Hey, now we got it. Proper
welcome.
Hey,
look at us.
Welcome in, Raiders.
That was aggressive. That was an aggressive intro. Look at us.
Look at me when I'm talking to you.
Welcome in, everybody. And here we go. So anyways, thank you guys for the raid. I really do appreciate it. Welcome in. What were you playing last? BioShock Remastered. Holy crap, nice. Brandon, can you tilt your camera down? You look like you're...
No, it's a vibe.
It's a vibe.
Don't mess with
yes.
me.
No, not
yes.
that far down. Not that far down.
Yes.
Nobody wants
yeah, just
that.
Keep it. Just keep it down. Just keep it.
Okay, Grandma, calm down.
That's for the
my abs.
It's for the after show.
Lost one of my abs.
What the?
Why are you squeezing your abs like that?
It is very different. It is very different from where it was.
What is happening out
stop
here?
It. That needs to
similar vibe to BioShock.
Okay,
things
yeah. So,
evolved.
Anyways,
things
thanks for the raid. Thank you very much. My name is Dan. This is Nat 1 Fun, and you are currently watching Running Feywild, which we run every Wednesday evening.
Every other Wednesday.
Every
yeah,
other
sorry.
Wednesday evening. Anyways, welcome in, and you are going to experience whatever the fuck just went down. So, as you walk out of the employees-only section, well, you get up to the bramble, and you say, what?
Pixie sparkles.
Nate whispers pixie sparkles into the thing, and all of a sudden, they start to open, and you hear, as the burly, as the furball like gentleman that lets you in with a pumpkin on his head gets startled with it opening.
I'm gonna slap on the back. Hey pumpkin, do you you know where a Kenku is?
No. And he kind of looks at you and he like rubs his back where you hit. He's like, wait.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, he kind of like wait. And he looks around. And he's like, he goes pixie sparkles, and it closes. And he looks over at you as a group, and he goes, hey, what the... isn't that Mr. White's? Or Mr. Light's? Excuse me.
Uh-oh.
What? No, this is a candy. And you just see him, this is like a lollipop. He sticks it in his mouth.
In your head, you hear, get me out of your mouth! Oh! I'm not something to eat!
Is it the rotating butterfly end?
It is.
Yeah. So it's like,
man,
it's rotating in your hand.
Like little
right
things
there.
Popping out on the cheek.
He 100% believes you. He's like, oh, okay. Anyways, And he looks around again, and he takes his pumpkin head off. And this time, you can see now his full face. He has kind of like a dog-like face, and kind of like a, but like a flat snout. You can see metal-wise, you can see what looks to be a bugbear in front of you. And he looks again. He looks kind of back and forth, but then he looks at you and he says,
"Look, bad things have been happening here at the carnival for quite some time, quite a while. People and things have gone missing. Like my bosses, they know that more than they're leading on. I think their hands are tied though. Look, Mr. Witch and Mr. Light, they're good people. They really are. So whatever's going on around here, we need to figure it out. And you mentioned a Kenku, right?"
"Yeah, they want our help in catching somebody that's causing trouble."
"I don't know who's causing the trouble, but they mentioned something about a location called Prismere. I don't know what that is or where that is. But if you want answers, I would say probably figure it out from that individual. They might know
where,
what's going on."
"Where are they at?"
I don't know. I just said that they've been causing trouble."
"Are you saying we need to go find the Kenku that talked about Prismere to find out about Prismere?"
"Yeah, I mean, you said..."
"I think he's just reinforcing everything so far."
"Oh, okay. I was just wondering if..."
"No, I'm saying that you could find out what you need to know from the Kenku."
"Oh, okay. Well, see, I told you murder wasn't the best option always."
I'm just like...
"Yeah.
Okay, is there some sort of... I don't know what the Kenku got on to talk to everybody in the tent, but is there some sort of intercom system where we can just be like, hey, if you want to talk about Prismere, come to this tent and like bring the Kenku to us?
I don't know
that
what
that won't upset anyone.
Intercom is, but we have this thing called magic here. I don't know if you've
heard of it. Of course.
Yeah, so.
Listen, we are officially sanctioned by those two now.
Yeah, no, I can see you're wearing at least that one's wearing a vest.
I work here.
Yeah, you said that when you walked in. Do you not work here? You say it like you were lying to me.
I work here.
Well, Carl, you don't work here, right?
Grandma's vest is really tight.
Yeah, it is.
Like, intentionally.
Grandma's vest is just open, right?
It's, like, almost painted on.
It's kind of like one of those things that you always see in ads on the internet for, like, hey, fix your posture with this half a backpack. It's just like two pieces of elastic doing this.
It just shoves his shoulders back, so you're just popping with muscles at this point.
I thought it was gonna be like a sports bra thing where it's just so tight and it doesn't go all the way.
Yeah,
I'm probably gonna rip it any minute now, and it's just gonna be like two
little
armbands.
Yeah, two armbands.
He's so, like, that doesn't
just,
really
just
fit.
Just make sure to do it while in Svara's eyeline, please. Thank you.
And out of Nate's.
Thank you.
Right.
I'll make sure you're there too, Nate.
So,
no.
All I'm saying is, what are you looking for, really?
Well, Mr. Light said that we need to look for trouble that's been caused.
Right, yeah. If you're going to be looking for the Kenku, that would be the easiest.
Okay, so do you have, like, a security place that we can, like, get updates when trouble is caused?
No, but that would probably be smart if we had one.
Yeah,
like that. No,
you don't have security at your car?
That's what do you think I am? You look down and you see a little tag that says security on
but
it.
But you don't have communication between each other?
Yeah.
How are you supposed to call for help?
Like this. Help.
All right.
I'm
gonna,
I can see
I'm gonna,
why
like,
a Kenku has you all turned on
I'm
your
I'm gonna
heads.
Turn my like head towards the open space and listen for a sec to hear for any help.
A little radar comes out of your ear and starts to
Like the Iron Giant.
Like the Iron Giant, yeah, for sure. It starts to, like, boom, boom, boom.
Well, where was the last disturbance that took place?
Right fucking here, you were there.
Okay, before that, is there a pattern? Is there something like...
And then right before that was probably the last disturbance. From what I heard, there was a massacre over at the fucking wrestling pit.
Yeah, that was us.
We should just probably go and see what we find. I think, guys, I think we should just go look for stuff and
are
see if
we
find
Kenku?
Anything. Oh shit!
Are we the
along the way?
Our group name is the Troublesome Kenku.
Wait, are you a Kenku? No, no, he just kind of was like, yeah, I don't know. You're just gonna.
What does it look like?
All right, like it looks like a bird. Like a bird.
Like a big bird.
You should have been more descriptive.
Like a bird is a word.
Because every bird that we see from now on.
All right. So I don't keep calling you Pumpkinhead. What's your name, Pumpkinhead?
Burly.
Burly?
Burly.
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 That's more of an adjective than a name, but I'll take it.
Hey, what's your name, Robot Man?
My name's Nate.
Nate.
Captain.
Okay. Well.
It says captain right here, but like
my name tag.
It's under the vest though, like I have to move the vest.
Quite a bland name for a walking, talking robot.
But yeah, I need to keep a low profile.
Super low profile. You definitely were. It's working.
You wear a pumpkin on your head.
And he just like puts it back on.
Gentlemen, please, let's just go about our business and let's just go.
And he just like, he looks like he's kind of huffing and puffing, and he's like, just figure out what's going on. And you leave Mr. Witch and Mr. Light out of it.
As I'm walking away, I'm going to turn my head over my shoulder and say, Pixie Sparkles.
Yeah. Pixie Sparkles. He like whispers it back, and it closes halfway, and he's like, God damn it. And you walk away. Where are you heading?
As we're walking away, Svara will say, there clearly is a magic way to get your voice on the speaker. That's what the captain did. So we should just, I really think we should do that and call them to us.
I mean, we can just shout real loud.
What, Kenku? Seems a bit
no, but like whatever you're going to say over the intercom. Like, do you know how to use magic? Can you use magic?
I can use magic, but not that kind of magic.
I've accidentally used some magic, yeah.
That's unfair. I'm just big.
You picked your class.
It must really suck to be big. I'm so sorry. You're cursed with height.
I'm gonna pick Noah up.
You picked your class.
I'm gonna pick Noah up and be like, hold him like now he's like 10 feet in the sky. Just be like, you see
do
anybody?
I see anything? Do I? Yeah. Let's just like. I'm gonna like use this.
Man, you became docile quick.
Yeah, dude. I was just like. I'll use this to my advantage. Whatever.
While I'm up here, I might as well. Yeah, so you get held up high and you start to swing back and forth like on your collar as you are being held up. And as you are swinging from side to side over by the lake, you can see that there are swans, you know, like I had said before, there are like large swans that people are kind of paddle boating inside of. But next to that, you see that there are gigantic dragonflies that are flying into what looks like a dock-like area and then lifting up in the air, and they look to be just, because there's like a bunch of them, there's like five or six of them in the air, they look to just be doing like a big circle in the air, coming back down and landing at the little dock again.
I'll grab Captain's wrist and then do like a flip, and so I'm like crouched on his thing because apparently I'm more agile than I should be. So I mean, it's just like, guys, flying things. What if we look from up over there and see?
What I'll say, what catches your attention, because you were up like that as well, is the fact that not just the fact that there's dragonflies over there. That was what you saw over there, but what you hear is
also stuff's happening.
So there's like dragonflies over there. Also, someone's dying. I don't know.
All right, which which direction?
Maybe we shouldn't go over there. You know what?
Well, I thought we go. We're going towards the shenanigans. Towards shenanigans.
Yeah, which direction, Noah?
This is true. Over there. Yeah, you know,
Noah. Do you point in the direction of where it is?
We'll hear people going. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
All right, what is
half figured Noah would point in the opposite direction.
I was gonna, but then like.
What is in between me and that direction?
A field.
Okay, it's open.
Yeah, it's an open field.
Okay. Hold on, wait.
Are you
gonna chuck
motor?
Me? Oh, I thought you were gonna chuck me.
I thought about it, but I don't think I can carry you that far.
You motherfucker, you're just gonna throw me.
You never toss a dwarf. Wait, not a dwarf.
Oh god.
It's fine. You toss him all you want.
Alright. I'm gonna like, forgetting how high he is, like just barely lower him and then drop him.
That's like an 8-foot fall, dude. Noah, you managed to take 6! Oh!
Hold on. Do I get to roll something? Like a dex save?
You can try to break my fall? Damage. Yeah, do you have feather fall? You take 6 points of damage as you land on your neck.
Whoa!
Can I try to make it so I don't land on my neck?
Oh no! My God. You can't! That's not how this works!
Oh no!
It wasn't that high!
How much? Alright, how much damage?
6!
Okay, good.
Max, how much HP do you have?
I just want you to know that as you hear all the bones crunching, right? as you hear all the crunching, and then you hear me like. I'm on the ground bleeding because I'm really bleeding now. I'm like, oh God, why are you so fucking tall? So fucking tall.
I'm gonna be like,
no, you're paradigmic.
No, it's fine. It's fine.
Paramedic. Right.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
No,
I'm gonna
fine.
Bend over and be like, I don't know dragon bones.
I don't even know if you're near me. I'm just doing. It's fine. No, I'm fine. It's fine. I have two HP. I'm about to die.
I'm gonna start just like poking various points of him.
Okay.
No. I'm on the ground. I'm like rolling ground.
I'm gonna crouch down next to him.
Can you feel this? And then I'm gonna like pinch his toes.
You take 1 point of damage.
No.
Oh my God!
No.
I see the light, right? So I'm seeing the light,
Nate,
and then I'm like,
back
and then
off.
And then Grandma says something, and then I'm gonna look at Grandma. I'm crying. I'm crying now, and I was like, Abuela. And my hand's gonna go to your face, and I was like, I missed you.
Okay, he's about to die. Nate, back off, you keep hurting him.
Blood.
Wait, I think I took some healing something. We're not supposed to waste this right now, but I guess here we are. Sara's just gonna like...
I'm twitching.
I'm gonna apply homeopathic medicine.
What are you doing?
Sara's gonna like be like, heal? And hope that casts Cure Wounds.
Okay.
Motherfucker.
So, Spuda, what does it look like when it does actually work? Because we'll say it does, so.
Okay. When...
No. Can I take the reins?
Yeah, it's fine, yeah.
No, I'm saying, Spuda, may I take the reins?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Spuda, whenever you cast the healing word, you're like, and you're like, maybe like a good, like, 2 feet away from him, like, trying not to, like, encroach in his space.
Mm-hmm.
You suddenly feel like you're not alone. Like, almost like somebody is behind you. And you hear in your head, oh my gosh, that is like so gross. Okay, well, just here. And spectral arms. Two spectral arms. Kind of pop up from around your shoulders and touch Noah on the ground. Go ahead and heal Cure Wounds. Or I'm sorry, go ahead and cast Cure
Wounds. Cast Cure
Wounds. Yep.
Alrighty.
Oh, I think that's worse. What is happening?
7?
What?
7 points back to you, Noah.
That's all of it.
Yeah.
I'm back to that was all the damage that was done
exactly
to me.
Exactly how much damage was done. And do you see the hands like that were touching Noah? Like that kind of went out really slow. They now come back, but quickly, and they're like this. And Spudda, in your head, you're like, ew, 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 ew.
Yeah.
Was Grandma holding me, or were you just nearby?
Not yet. I'm crouching like. Right, Grandma was next concerned. To you. So like, okay. Don't look up because.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, there's that'll definitely like a haunted
that,
look.
That next point of damage will come.
It'll be
psychic. It'll
8
be a psychic
points
point.
Of damage. I'm dead.
Or is it bludgeoning? Never mind. No.
Oh. God.
Only if you kneel down, Grandma. No.
This is Feywild After Dark content.
I don't know what you guys think you came to see, but
you're within range.
Feeling a lot less dying. I will like stand up very quickly, like clamber up, like
yeah,
and just look awkwardly at everybody. And then just walk, just go.
Okay, all right.
I'm gonna take out my notepad and write down kobolds equal weak bones.
Okay, all right, sounds good.
Grandma and Nate are gonna be at the back of the group having a talk.
Spudda, Spudda. Yes.
This is how you play nice.
Inside your head, you go, you hear, like, who are you even?
Who are you?
No, like, what's your name? Like, who are you?
Oh, I'm Svara or Sithara, depending on, you know, who you're asking, but who are you?
Well, you don't need to worry about it. I don't need to tell you. Well.
Okay, nameless voice in my head. I'm gonna call you Alexa.
That's.
It's mad now.
I don't like you. Just so you know that.
Well,
I don't like you.
The feeling's mutual. You're in my head and you won't tell me who you are.
Well, maybe you'll just have to find out then.
Hmm.
Anyways.
I think outwardly, Svara just humps and like smacks into Santosh as he's walking by.
Santosh in the meantime has just subconsciously been looking at the vein because he forgot that it's not a lollipop.
Does it taste like anything?
Metal and jewels?
Some old
metal and jewels.
I mean, he's a dragon, man. Dragons love shiny things. The dragonborn.
All right. So,
dude, watch where you're going, dude.
In your head, Spudda, again, you would just hear, well, I'm kind of like a part of you. Now, I guess. I don't know why or when I got here, but I'm here. And I'm not happy, and you're not happy, so we're just gonna have to fucking work this out.
Oh. Well, you know, I'm not even supposed to be here, so...
Neither am I, so let's just get through this.
Okay, fine. Do you need anything from me?
Don't even fucking acknowledge my existence. I'll talk to you when I will talk to you, okay?
No. Okay. All right. That works for me. Doesn't seem very nice. He must not be from the Midwest, clearly. But we'll make it work.
Look, I didn't come here to be nice, okay? I came here because I had to be.
Not fair. I mean, I came here because I fell through a pot of chili.
You hear kind of almost like they're walking away somehow in your own head. You hear, care.
Bye. All right. Okay. So I'm losing my mind. That's fine. And I think that's the only thing you hear Svara say out loud.
Okay.
I feel like Santos definitely would have heard it. And he goes, join the club, dude.
As he munches on this piece of metal.
By the way, speaking of which.
Yeah.
So... I just read something very special about this thing.
Mm-hmm.
So we are still considered in the carnival, right?
That is correct.
Oh, that's beautiful. So this fantastic little thing has a very fun little thing called Sense Mood, which says, while the vein is inside the perimeter of the Witchlight Carnival, It can sense the mood of every creature in the carnival that has an intelligence of 4 or higher.
Mm-hmm.
As an action, a creature attuned to the vein can use it to pinpoint the location of the happiest creature in the carnival. And the butterfly shape at the top of the vein spins slowly clockwise, then spirits the carnival are when spirits in the carnival are generally high. If the general mood in the carnival is dour, the top of the vein spins slowly counterclockwise.
Hence, the
which
slow
direction
spinning.
Is this vein? Is it spinning counterclockwise slowly?
Yeah, it was spinning slowly counterclockwise.
Okay, so I hope I didn't divulge something that I shouldn't have. Like,
no, I mean, you kind of use the item the way it's supposed to be used, I guess.
Okay, well, actually, I haven't had the chance to attune to it. Am I already attuned to it?
We'll say that you're not attuned to it, but you can. We'll say that because it's sentient and it's talking to you, obviously. The sense mood thing comes naturally. The magic weapon portion of it and the additional properties and all that stuff, that comes with attunement.
Gotcha. Would I be able to use it to help find perhaps someone who seems especially sad? Like either upset, sad, outside of, you know, I'm assuming Mr. Light over there.
You get two pings on your radar from where you are currently located. One is very sad. One is just like just sadness, really. Just you just get a feeling of sadness. The other is a feeling of frustration. And the feeling of sadness is coming from what you look over and see the House of Mirrors. You see that is where the source of sadness is coming from. The source of frustration is coming from the direction that Noah had pointed in, as there is yelling and screaming off in the distance.
Ooh. Okay, so frustration does not quite match, quite itself sense like danger, just frustration, or like frustration that seems to be coming from, I'm in freaking danger, nothing seems to be working.
No, that would be more like fear.
So frustration, they're not in danger.
Frustration and like anger.
Okay.
Somebody could be raising hell because they're frustrated.
Gotcha. So yeah, that I will avoid.
Somebody could be frustrated because somebody else is raising hell.
Or somebody could be frustrated because they were dropped and almost killed.
I don't think that doesn't sound plausible.
But did you die?
Did you die though?
No, not yet.
So Santosh is like, so I'm kind of getting a general vibe, man. Like just some sort of like
vibe check.
Vibe check, bro.
Yeah. As you hear in your head, vibe check!
Dude, can you... You're so cool, man. You can tell people's vibes?
Yeah, man. I can do vibe checks all day.
All day, all night?
What?
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Like, all right, okay. Well, do you know what that dude over there, why he's so sad?
No, I just know that he is sad.
You think we should check it out?
You're the one with legs, man.
I'm just asking your opinion.
What are your legs broken? Whatever.
Kind of following me around because I kind of have to.
I mean, I have to follow you around because you're carrying me.
Yeah, but I still want to. I
want
to just
look. If you want my opinion, I don't like it when people are sad. But I also don't like it when people are angry or anything but happy.
Dude, same.
Looks like one of your friends is quite angry right now.
Yeah, I mean, we kind of all are kind of going through a thing, but, you know, I think he kind of just got dropped and kind of bumped his head or something. You know, like Humpty Dumpty, kind of.
I literally saw his friend drop him. Yeah, that happened.
Yeah. Alleged.
In the distance, you're going to see Noah fidgeting with something.
Have you already walked off, Noah, by the way?
I was walking off a little bit. I didn't go too far.
Okay.
But like, I just walked off a little bit, and I need to fidget with something to get my mind to distract off things.
Yeah.
So the only thing I have is I reach for the one thing I brought with me that I can fidget with. And you're all going to see Noah with his left hand very practiced, and he's flicking open a butterfly knife. And it's this black butterfly knife, and he's just looking in the distance, but his left hand is opening and closing this butterfly knife. Opening and closing.
Your grandma thinks it's a fidget spinner.
It might as well be. It might as well be. And he's just like...
Like, Santosh looks at that, looks at his wand, he's like, probably need to just just we could just maybe leave him a little alone, you know? Maybe I don't want to get stabbed, dude.
Grandma's
so, as Noah, you spin the fidget spinner. Santosh, you get the weird sensation of feelings. Off in the distance, you hear the screaming and everything like that. And then suddenly, coming out of the sky, a giant dragonfly is heading straight for all of you and crash lands into the ground, kicking up a bunch of dust and throwing its passengers off as they fly through the air and slam into like a pile of trash and popcorn and everything like that. It goes flying up in the air. And off in the distance, you see a shadowy figure with the face of a crow and a purple robe on. Look over in your general direction and you hear, "Fuck! What the fuck? Help me! Ah!" And that's where we're going to end today's session.
Damn it! Damn it!
Wow.
Upset.
All right. So, on that note, thank you all for joining us tonight for this night's session of Running Feywild. What an excellent time! I hope you all enjoyed yourselves. We had a near death today, so that was enjoyable.
Really cool. Really fun.
No epic.
Yeah,
so
I burned a first level spell out of combat. It's fine.
Yeah.
We'll be fine.
That's the first big spell. Like I didn't like we've done cantrips, but that's the first big spell.
We're level one. I have two spell slots. We're gonna be fine.
Hey, I used all five lay on hands to get rid of bubble high.
We should have just done one.
We've used all our bonus class features before anything happened. Before anything dope happened, we burned all our shit.
I mean, you did fight some goblins, so that kind of.
Yeah. Well, okay, that's true. We did fight some gobbos.
I used wine to boo at a crowd and blow bubbles, okay?
You know what? This is exactly what people who have been. I'm about to say something else. Who've been isekai'd into, you know what I was about to say, who've been isekai'd into a D&D game we're going to do. They're going to fuck around with magic.
Exactly.
Yeah, I mean,
exactly.
Yeah.
Without knowing.
Welcome to fucking Running Feywild, everybody. So anyways, thank you all for joining me. If you're watching on YouTube, please subscribe to the channel as we will be putting out content every week with either this or we will be putting out like our interviews or we will be putting out, you know, all the other streams that we do on this channel. But definitely keep an eye out for Running Feywild coming out here in the future, the near future. Thank you all for watching. I do appreciate it. Real quick, let's go around the table, as we always do, and kind of tell everybody where people can find you. We'll start off with Pooja.
Hello, everybody. I am Pooja. You can find me over on the Twitter place, at Pooja, and at Poojabberwocky on Instagram, Twitch, and other places. I am frequently popping up in various corners of the internet on tabletop streams, and for the most current information, Twitter's the place, or my link tree, which is Poojabberwocky, and it's also linked in my Twitter bio, so come hang out, say hi, and watch shenanigans ensue everywhere I go.
Excellent. KP.
Hello, everybody. My name is KP. I go by KP Levin Studios on all your social medias, and outside of this fantastic campaign. Tomorrow I'll be on one of our Raiders Today's channel, Unmade Gaming, where I get to play our weekly game of Coriolis campaign called Void. And we're slowly heading into some end of not just a campaign, but end of just world scenario, end of universe apocalyptic level stuff that is possibly about to happen. We have genies all over rampant. We have random ancient spires that can shoot out and destroy galaxies a la Mass Effect level stuff, and just a whole bunch of things that are happening all at once, both science level and magic level things that are all out there to kill us. And please come and support, and so that way we can possibly maybe, somehow survive this, perhaps.
Love it. I always love when science is mixed with magic in these games. That is literally, I'm not even kidding, that is like one of my favorite genres of game, when science mixes with magic, and you can kind of explain explain how things work. You know, like, it doesn't necessarily really work that way, but it's totally legitimate. It could work if there was, you know, a little bit of...
I mean, if it doesn't, and if you don't know if that's how it works, you just go magic.
Exactly.
Just magic. Deal with it. So yeah, that's tomorrow. And I think we're like maybe 2 episodes, maybe 3 episodes away from reaching our finale is what is possibly going to happen.
Oh,
if that's
great.
The end of it, we don't know. But if anything, the journey is going to be fantastic. And hopefully y'all will be able to join us. And then on Friday, we're going to have a fun special episode of our weekly Fate Light campaign called City of Light and Shadows on Academic Foxhole's channel, which is, if you like killing Nazis or punching Nazis or beating them up in any sort of fashion, any fascism, any of that junk, we are the show for you. Come join. What better way to spend your Fridays than punching Nazis? We literally blew up a platoon of them using landmines that we configured and chucked them like grenades. And then shot the survivor in cold blood, because fuck it, Nazis.
Fucking inglorious bastards over here.
It's very
dark. Oh yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
With a little heart, my character is the type that is a humanitarian and sees like the one 18-year-old boy. You're like, but why? He's a child. They're like, nope, Nazi. Bam. So, you know.
Yes, that's
what it is. It is what it is. So if you like any sort. So basically we're a what-if campaign set in the 1940s mm-hmm. during a Nazi-occupied France, and we're a bunch of secret agents undercover in this space trying to unravel it from within. So if any of that sounds intriguing to you, if you like espionage, if you like political intrigue, if you like actual history being woven masterfully by our GM, Academic Foxhole, oh man, it's beautiful. It's some of the things, and he's been fantastic with my character integrating a lot of Indian history. I just met one of the major freedom fighters that were prominent in actual Indian, you know, history, and talking to him and seeing the political play for India, who was like, well, fuck the British. If that means we have to, you know, shake hands with Nazis, maybe that's what we need to do to free India. And you're just like, which of these two evils do I pick? What the F, man?
Yeah, so that's pretty rough.
A lot of just... It was a lot of fun, a lot of stress, but really, really fun. And if any of that sounds fun to you, please come join us. Tomorrow's going to be a special episode where it's just going to be two of us. It's going to be me and my wonderful co-player, Lindy. And we are going to get into a lot of shenanigans. So do join us there. I'm going to be not on stream next week because I'm going to be on a cruise as a photographer for a special event that's happening on there.
Yep.
So I'll be over there. But that's it for now. And I'll be back the following week for further streams of this wonderful show with you.
Woohoo! Right on.
Wait, Taylor! Are we playing next week or the week after?
Negative.
Week after.
Tate!
Good evening. Good evening, everyone. Bam! I'm Tay, your grandma. Please
grandma.
Take your shoes off before you come in the house. Do not touch the walls with your jelly hands. And, those candies on the table have been there for 46 years, but you can have one if your mom's not looking. amazing. And if she sees, it's grandma's house, baby. But you know the rules. Yes, Taylor.
Taylor, where can they find you?
at my house. Grandma's
house. There's a process.
House.
Oh, okay. It's grandma's house.
Process.
You can find her at
Look,
grandma's
I'm
house.
Sorry. I'm too deep in, okay? Like, you can't just snap back out of this
the
method
The investment
acting.
Is
like,
real. Yeah, it's method.
I'm going to be this for the next day. Like,
yeah,
anyway.
I get it.
Anyway, I guess I'll be someone else for Dan. yeah, you can find me on the Twitter. That's where I live some of the time, and it's right down there. It's my name, Tay Fun Bullion. That's how you say it. I'm sure everybody was wondering.
Van Biljon.
It's not a hard J. It is a daily battle.
Yeah.
You know how it is.
I think many of us have pretty
I know how it is because I get it the other way a lot.
Yeah. We have very non I guess.
It's
native.
Okay if you don't say it that way. I'm so desensitized at this point that like I get called it ain't the worst thing people be calling me. That's the truth. Now on a daily basis. But that's where I live, Twitter, and, like, you know, other places like Discord, Iceland, that one's real. But, you know.
Where can they find you? Iceland. That's where they can find you.
I'm not even kidding. Like, that's really, like, if you are here, you actually do have to pay the Taylor tax.
They're not going to Where's Waldo you?
I'll find you, though. There's 10 of us out here.
That's true.
Like,
that's true.
You can't visit and don't tell me.
That's
I'll
fair.
Find out.
Got it.
I'll find out. But otherwise, if you're, like, not making the trip, rude, you can find me on Backwater Bastards, a sci-fi comedy podcast, space opera extravaganza that's, like, at this point, we've done 2 campaigns, so there's, like, well over 150 episodes, but we are currently on a sci-fi campaign that's, like, over 75 episodes, so there's, like, a minute to listen to, and it comes out every other Thursday, bi-weekly, so you can listen to it whenever the hell you want. You don't have to listen to it this Thursday, even though there's one coming out this Thursday, and on Backwater Bastards, I'm a human bear named Cleo. You're gonna have to listen to find out what that means. It's a lot.
But it's a lot.
It's a lot. It's a lot. If you think this is a lot, well,
you,
this is a
you
lot.
Have a gun.
I have a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
To
Do you like
be
things
really
that
honest.
Go boom as well?
A lot of things that go boom. But you know what? That's like my full-time gig, but I'm also here every other Wednesday now, and like
yeah,
if you don't come back, you're actually committing a crime against a grandma, which I think we all know where that puts you when you die.
Listen to her. That's true.
It's yep. true. It's true. Don't mess
grandma
with
knows
that.
Best.
That's the ancient magic there. Respect your grandmother and everybody else's, because otherwise you'll go straight to the DMV, right? That's
all right. Jesus Christ. All right. Thanks, Tay.
Anyway, yeah, like, I do other stuff. If you want to know about it, you're going to have to find me on Twitter because, like, that's the law. Bye.
God damn it.
Oh, God.
Judy.
Yes.
Pick up.
Hi, everybody. I have things this time. Yay. Hi, I'm Juni Ruiz. I'm a very nerdy dad. You can find me on Twitter at Juni Ruiz. I'm on TikTok at Professor Juni. I was recently on the Very Random Encounters podcast, where we got to play, the game. I'm sure you're all wondering why I've gathered you here this evening. That's the full title. And I got to play with the creator, Logan Jenkins, I'm a part of their little mini series that they do. They take a mini series, between seasons. They played, this other one page RPG with Grant Howitt, last season, like 2-3 weeks ago. And then, we're on episode 2 of the like 3 that I got to play with them, and it was
awesome.
Really fun. And check it out. That's at VRE Cast on Twitter or VRE.show. Sometimes I'm on The Last Game Board doing Whose Role Is It Anyway, where they give us random character sheets as soon as the stream starts. We don't see it beforehand, and I just have to roll with it. So that's fun. What else? I'm here. I'm here every Wednesday. Even if we're not streaming, I'm here. I'm here. I'm in Dan's closet. He won't let me go. If I take this down, you'll see Dan on the other side of this fucking green screen. See Dan.
I live in this closet, and you can see every inch of my workspace.
Wow. It's a green screen, y'all. Don't listen to him. Who are you gonna listen to? He almost killed me today.
This is true.
I mean, don't listen to him.
Quick,
but
we all need help.
Yes. Yes.
Please,
so
like and subscribe.
Like and subscribe for more death. But yeah, I'm on the Very Random Encounters podcast. I did this other thing. Also, I have a secret thing that I don't tell people about, and that's a funny gag for me.
Oh.
That that's a thing. It's a secret. Find it if you can. I dare. It's a challenge at this point. I shouldn't be talking about it, but whatever. It's funny. Secrets. And that's it. Thank you all. I want to thank everybody else here.
Y'all, we need to work on this outro.
No,
I may really
that was some weird stuff.
I've been practicing this for months.
All right. Brandon,
you
where
mean
can
I'm
they find
you?
I'm
not supposed to read the teleprompter.
Good night.
All right.
Good night. That's where you can find Nate. You
Alexa,
can find him.
Help.
You gotta take
she
over
walked
that Twitter.
Away.
You really have to do that.
Yeah. You really gotta shout out your Twitter
Alexa.
That you have not yet used.
You have to take
I am
you have
used
to take
it
Brandon's
to follow
Twitter and
everybody
make it all...
else.
Okay, well, All right. Anyways, yeah, Brandon doesn't really have an online present, but you can find him here every other Wednesday here on Running Feywild.
He's going to have an online presence once I hack it.
Sure.
I'll just give it to you.
Yeah, take it.
And my name is Dan Munoz, and I
since when?
Am the leader. I don't know. Since,
Dandelion.
Yeah, since right. we started
40
this
years
campaign.
Ago?
Oh, well, whoa. First off, whoa.
Jesus.
That was off, a, that was whoa. Criminal, what you did.
It's savage. Not off by much.
Look, a lady doesn't.
Brother on brother violence.
A lady doesn't tell
Nate,
her age,
Nate,
okay?
Sit down. You've right. been so bad today.
So, anyways.
Stop standing.
You can find me everywhere on the internet at Nat1Fun. So just type in Nat1Fun, whatever website you're on, and you'll probably find me. You can find me here every other Wednesday for Running Feywild, and you can find me every Monday where we do an improv show for an hour. And then on Saturday, we do the Rime of the Frostmaiden campaign, which we are coming to an end probably here within the next few months of gameplay. Other than that, you can find me here in the future in a lot of stuff. There's a lot of secret stuff going on behind the scenes. I am working with Gehenna Gaming. I am going to PAX East at the end of April. And I have a lot of stuff going on. So, yeah, keep an eye out for me. I'll be around. So anyways, thank you all for joining us. Yep. Well, I mean, I didn't mean it to be. So if it was, I guess that's what it is now. We are going to be raiding, and as always, we try to share the love. We are going to be raiding the Venture Maidens today, and I'm trying to raid femme-only streams this month, as we are going to make sure that we show our love to the opposite sex here. Let's see. So, Venture Maidens, let's go ahead and slash raid. Guys, let them know where you came from. Let them know that we are... The raid is being created. Okay, cool. Let them know that we are happy to be there. And, of course, if you can, show some love by following and subbing if you can. So, thank you all for joining us tonight. Keep being your best selves. And we'll see you next... Well, nope, 2 weeks from now. Huh? Every other week. All right, guys. Bye, everyone. See you later.